I'm Mr. Game Show. Brace yourself for some true game show madness, because you are about to see some of the hottest.
I'm sorry.
Sickest.
When you answer a question correctly, you down a shot of your own urine.
Wildest. And tastiest moments on television.
Because it's dog food.
So get ready for more fun than a key party at Chuck Woolery's pad. It's the most awesome highlights from game show history on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Now, here's your host, the man who's seen his share of bells, buzzers, and bad consolation prizes, Mr. Ben Stein.
Thanks, Mr. Game Show. Over the years, I've been a teacher, an author, an actor, a presidential speechwriter, but I probably had the most fun being a game show host. And unlike in politics, in game shows, the loser usually receives a consolation prize. But some clueless contestants deserve nothing more than to be mocked mercilessly, which is what we love to do. Here's what I mean.
We surveyed 180-year-old men, and we asked them, do you think that rock star Madonna is sexy? Maury, what do you think? You know who Madonna is?
I've seen maybe a couple of times. Yeah. I don't even know what he does. Is he sings or dance or what? Yeah.
We asked 100 people to name a reason for standing up quickly. Peter.
Going to church.
Sitting there on a Sunday morning, oh, my God! Oops, I said God. I better go to church.
All right, players, tell me what type of vehicles are used to compete in the legendary Tour de France. Alan again.
SUVs.
Name? A vegetable you marinate.
Grapes.
Okay, first off, I'm going to ask you, Jermaine. Who do you think of your fellow contestants has had sex in front of 50 people?
I'll say Cool Deep.
Why would you say that?
Just looks like the type.
Well, you're absolutely right, she is the type. Cool Deep, you've had sex in front of 50 people.
It was actually a fetish club.
At a fetish club?
Yeah.
Is this a hobby or a job?
A hobby.
Yeah.
I
collect stamps.
That is Jimmy Carr, a familiar face on British game shows. A familiar face on American game shows in the 80s was the great Bert Convy. Bert hosted such classic shows as Tattletales and Super Password. Unfortunately, Bert sometimes thought he was a contestant. Take a look.
The password is roll.
Ken, roll. Uh-oh, I said the word.
He's so bad.
Next word, please. Cloth.
Why did you do that?
Vicky and Dicky. Oscar? I mean, Dick. Oh!
It's the first time I have ever looked in there and said the word.
The password is blunder. You know, game show hosts are responsible for some of the most memorable TV bloopers ever. And what better person to present the top five host screw-ups than the host of Greed, Scrabble, and, of course, Love Connection, the inimitable Chuck Woolery.
You know, hosting a game show is not something you should try at home. Not only would that be slightly, well, creepy, it's a bad idea because hosting is best left up to us professionals. Of course, we've been known to make the occasional mistake. Despite our superior intelligence and great hair, we're not infallible. And in that spirit, I bring you the top five host screw-ups of all time, beginning with this moment from Match Game. Take a look.
And here's the star of Match Game, Ross Schaefer!
Well, there's a step you don't see too often. That's got to hurt. So who's guilty of host screw-up number four? Stick around. You're gonna find out right now. Or no, no. Well, no, you're not gonna find out right now. It'll be a little bit later. There was a host screw-up right there.
Coming up, distraction makes buzzing in a lot more interesting and painful.
There's just an ordinary buzzer in the middle of those cacti.
And contestants deliver everyone's favorite punchline.
And we're going with Michael Jackson.
Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
This is Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. You know, not just any fool can become a contestant on a game show. It takes a very special breed of fool. You must have a strong command of the English language.
Name something you do when visitors are expected.
Bake.
Pardon?
Bake.
Make a cake. Never heard that before. Is that a northern expression?
B-A-K-E.
Oh, bake! Bake. I say bake, bake!
A game show contestant must have lightning-fast reflexes.
Good luck. We surveyed 100 people, top 5 answers on the board. Give me the most popular answer.
Must have a near photographic memory.
Nancy, tell us about yourself, please.
I'm
now, wait a minute.
I'm so nervous.
You had a funny life?
She's hiding the Mandalay.
No. No, take a deep breath.
I'm married. I know that.
You are? Okay.
And?
You live in?
Huntington Beach.
That's right. You live in Huntington Beach and you're married. What's his name? It's gonna be all right. Sam? George.
Dave, he's right.
Dave. I knew it was in my head. All right.
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
How long you been married?
5 years.
5 years.
And above all, a game show contestant must be ready when her big opportunity comes.
Patricia Bernard, come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right. Just a moment. An emergency has occurred. Would you believe this moment had to occur, did it not? Patricia has gone to the little girl's room. A gentleman, whom I assume is her husband, has rushed out to get her. A page has gone after the gentleman. Everyone in America is wondering how long can they wait for Patricia. Here comes Patricia!
This next moment is from a show called Distraction, where the players have a unique way of ringing in.
I'm going to ask you a series of simple questions. All you've got to do is buzz in when you know the answer. There's just an ordinary buzzer in the middle of those cacti. Okay, first question. Cowboys and Angels was a hit for which ex-Wham singer? Anna.
George Michael?
George Michael, yes, you're correct. Which film features the character Woody the Cowboy?
Toy Story.
Yeah, Toy Story.
That wouldn't hurt.
I think this game would be considerably funnier if you wore blindfolds.
Oh.
Grab your blindfolds. Okay, one more thing. We're going to rotate the cacti. Next question. Complete the title of the film, Butch Cassidy and...
The Sundance Kid.
Correct. What did American Indians live in?
TP.
Correct.
Oh, it's got my f***ing nail bed.
Which reggae star sang, I Shot the Sheriff? Anna.
Oh. Jimi Hendrix.
Reggae star.
Just when you thought it couldn't get any funnier, here's some more game show brilliance.
Him, please.
They love to fly over nudist camps. Okay, fill them in.
You.
No, that's incorrect. I'm sorry. Fill the blanks in order or pick a tile, Chris, whatever you want to do. Okay, fill them in.
I.
No, sir, that's incorrect. Okay, Vaughn, you want to continue with this?
S, please.
They love to fly over nudist camps. Fill them in.
A.
Wrong. I've never had this happen. It's the first time. Chris?
I know it.
You know it? All right, fill it in.
O.
Yes.
I.
Yes.
T.
Yes.
E.
Yes. Oh. I'm going home. I don't know about you.
Name something made of wool.
Sheep.
All right, your next missing initial you need to find. Let's see the first word. Okay, we have a missing letter there.
I dare you.
Anyone care to take a guess? Okay, let's move on to the next word quickly. Anyone yet? Could we have another word? Settle down out there. Show me the next word. Here it comes.
Oh, no. T.
Yes, Tarzan gave it away.
Name a time that most people get up.
In the morning.
A time most people go to bed.
At night.
Survey says it's time to play Family Feud. Let's meet our contestant, David Selsby. How are you, David?
Good. How are you?
Now, you are a substitute teacher.
Yes.
And where do you teach?
All over Pasadena and Glendale.
Awesome. Do they do their homework?
Yes.
They do. Part. They're totally different from any students I ever had. I'm going to ask you a series of five questions from actual Family Feud surveys. If your answers total 100, you'll win this cool prize.
It's Capsaicin HP Arthritis Pain Relief Cream. Capsaicin for deep, penetrating, odor-free arthritis pain relief.
That is what the girls used to call me at Yale. Get it? Deep, penetrating, and odor-free.
Got it.
All right, now you get it. All right, contestant, you know the rules, so let's play the feud. Name a part of the body that everyone has only one of.
Brain.
Excellent. You said brain. Survey said 31. Let's see how an actual contestant responded to the same question on the British version of feud called Family Fortunes.
We asked 100 people in our survey to name a part of the body everybody has only one of.
Sarah.
Big toe.
What's wrong with that? You've got two of them.
Okay, next question. Name a game played in the dark.
Hide and seek.
Very good. You said hide and seek. Survey said 7. Here's what the British contestant said.
Game, we asked 100 people to name a game played in the dark. Rob.
Charades.
Charades!
That's what we in America call charades. Okay. See, so the joke is you have to be watching people for it right. to work, so that's the joke of that.
Got
okay,
it.
Next question. Name a vocalist who's known by only one name.
Bono.
Very good. You said Bono. Survey said 28. How did our British contestant respond?
We surveyed 100 people and we asked them to name a vocalist who is known by one name.
Michael Sam. Jackson.
A vocalist who's known by one name.
Oh,
and
no,
we're going with
sorry.
Michael Jackson.
All right, next question. What's a noise your partner might make in the dark?
Cough.
Very good, cough. Survey said 31. That's a very good answer. The Family Fortune said this.
A noise your partner might make in the night.
Fart.
And our last question. Name something a dentist says.
Open up wide.
Very good. You said open up wide. Survey said 6. Congratulations, David. You won. I'm very excited. I don't think you're
Excellent.
Going to be needing this for a while. Let's see how your British counterpart fared.
We asked 100 people to name something a dentist says.
Just a small prick.
Oh. I never heard those words before, so I don't know what that means. But anyway, I guess it could have been worse. Thank you very much for playing. You're very kind. Thank you. Now, let's go to Chuck Woolery with another top five host screw-up.
You know, host screw-up number four is courtesy of Bill Cullen. And although Bill emceed more game shows than anyone else in television history, even he would slip up occasionally. Take a look at this episode of Blockbusters, and you'll see what I mean.
Question. What E would a doctor be examining if he were using an otoscope?
Ear?
Nope. The ear.
That's what I said.
Oh, I thought you said liver. I swear I thought you said liver. Well, actually, that's not wrong. If the otoscope is long enough, there's nothing impossible.
You get the liver too.
Ear is right, and you get...
All right. We got more screw-ups by hosts and host screw-ups and screw-up things just coming up. It's going to be back. We'll be here.
Coming up, a pair of curious clues pop up on Super Password.
Harry Palm. Richard?
I can't say it.
And no good answer goes unpunished.
When you answer a question correctly, you down a shot of your own urine.
No!
Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
This is Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Now, who else wants to play a little match game with me? Young madam, would you like to play?
I would.
Would you please stand up? What is your name?
My name is Megan.
And what do you do?
I am a fashion designer I'm a student of.
Excellent, excellent. Now, in a moment, I'm going to read you a phrase with a blank in it. Before the show, I wrote down my answer on this card. If you can match it, I'm going to give you a very game show type prize. Mr. Game Show, lay it on us.
Then it's Citracel Clear Fiber Supplement, the source of 100% soluble fiber for regularity, and it causes no excess gas.
Not a problem at your age, but someday it will be. Anyway, ready, Megan? Here's the phrase. Full of blank.
Crap.
Good answer. You could have said full of hot air, full of life, full of yourself, full of beans, full of it, but you said full of...
Crap.
Okay. Here is what I said. I am so sorry, Megan, but you made a good try at it, and we certainly appreciate it. Thank you very much. The longest-running game show of all time is The Price is Right. But maybe the announcer should have told these contestants to calm down before he told them to come on down. Take a look.
Vicki Brooks, come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
I prayed. Oh, God, I need to come.
Now, Vicki. I want you to get all of that out of your system down there. Hello!
Bobby Jean,
Ruby Jean, not over here, Ruby Jean. Right here, Ruby Jean. There you are. Now, Ruby Jean, you want to play a pricing game, don't you?
Yes.
And you want to play it right now,
yes,
don't you?
Yes, yes.
Now, will you explain to them why you get to play and they don't? What?
I'm
no.
Up here.
I've got one word for those contestants, Zoloft. This next contestant's motto is, if you don't have anything nice to say, say something nasty.
How would you change our Jane?
Major plastic surgery is me.
Yeah. plastic surgery here, how would you change him?
6 foot under. Straight.
If you like that, check out these moments.
For 100 people to name something done slowly at the weekend, but rushed in the week. You nearly rushed then.
Who?
Make love.
Just at the weekend, she slowed down.
Something to which you often lose your key.
What?
Pass.
Something to which you often lose your key.
Pass.
So I'm going to let her take one answer.
Thank you.
On one other question. All right?
Thank you.
Something to which you often lose your key.
What do you mean?
You have keys for lots of things. What would be one of the things you might have a key?
Car.
A car. Very well. Something to which you often lose your key.
Repeat the question?
Something to which you often lose your key.
Something to which a pass.
How can I phrase this for these children? You know keys do lots of things,
yes.
Right? Name something you'd have a key that you would use a key for. You might lose the key and you wouldn't be able to do with the key what the key was designed for. What?
You mean open a door?
A door key.
A door key.
Is that what they want?
Turn around.
Oh, okay.
Our final game is a drinking competition, but it's a drinking competition with a difference. And the difference is you made the drink yourself earlier.
No!
Our final this evening is a drinking contest with your own urine. I noticed, Jason, yours is a vastly different colour to Jez's.
Yeah, I hadn't drunk anything all day, so I was a bit dehydrated.
That would be a richer flavour, then. Let me explain the rules. When you answer a question correctly, you down a shot of your own urine. Question one. Long Island iced tea is a popular cocktail, but which U.S. state is Long Island in? Jez.
New York State.
Correct. Are you going to down it in one, or are you going to sip?
No, I'm going to down it.
You're going to down it?
Yeah.
Give him some encouragement. Go on, Jez. You seem to quite enjoy that.
Fruitier than I thought.
Tree.
Oh. Palm.
Yes!
Yes, exactly.
Like a palm tree, a date palm.
Oh, okay.
Palm is the word.
Harry Palm.
Richard?
I can't say it!
Okay, Harry. All right. I would have to say, is it dates? Date.
Is it dates?
Or lack of dates.
Name something you should do in moderation or you'll be sorry later. Lucy.
Sex.
The agent said to King Kong, hey, says Kong, baby, boy, have I got you a part in a terrific new movie. It's called Snow White and the Eight Dwarfs. You're the eighth dwarf, and you're going to be called Blanky.
Whitey.
Whitey!
Now let's meet an African explorer.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Peter Agababi Palangian.
Number two.
My name's the same as his.
Right, who's better looking, out of interest? For £255, Robin or Alex? I mean, it's a dead heat in the chest department.
Yeah, that's what's it's going through my mind. Yeah.
Be a photo finish, but what a photo.
Yeah, indeed.
All right, we're going to continue with today's game. Recap the scores, or recap them, actually.
On that note, let's go to Chuck Woolery with our next top host screw-up.
Host screw-up number three is from the show Safe Win, back in the days when the host used to do commercials live during the show. This actually used to happen. Watch Art James give the phrase commercial break a whole new meaning. Watch this.
And you know, Peter Pan is made to stay good as gold, fresh and moist, any time at all, from the first big swoop off the top of the jar right down to the last little bit at the bottom. So for happy young faces, at all times, Make sure you've got Peter Pan peanut butter on hand at bedtimes, all times. Or do you?
All right, we'll be more back with Screwing the Host Up. It's hosting the screw up. Host screws, host screw ups. What is it? Host screw ups. We'll be back in just a minute.
Coming up, distraction replaces buzzers with mouse traps. Let the painful hilarity commence. And it wouldn't be a game show without a titillating question from Match Game.
Hey, did you hear that Ronald McDonald has his picture in Playgirl magazine?
No.
Yeah, let me tell you about it. They got a great shot of his blank.
Hear the PG-13 answers next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. You know, game shows are so popular, they should have their own awards show. Best Supporting Actress would go to a contestant named Vanessa for this tearjerker role.
Well, Vanessa. Oh, baby. Yes, welcome to Life Can Be Beautiful.
The British show Blankety Blank would win an award for best writing.
All right, then, let's reveal the legend, please. Sausage Blank. Is that spelled wrong? It says soggy, you soft sod. I must be dyslexic, because I read that all right, didn't I? I must be.
And finally, this Family Feud moment would take home the trophy for best unintentional comedy.
During what month of pregnancy does a woman begin to look pregnant?
September.
Something. Oh.
If you like that, check out these moments.
Name a yellow fruit.
Orange.
Duh. It's a coin and the U.S. president who appears on it. Christian, your time starts now.
George Washington.
Quarter?
John F. Kennedy.
Nickel? Dime.
No, you have to do it again.
John F. Kennedy.
Kennedy.
Okay.
I don't think we'll ever forget that fabulous new word, Kennedy. Ooh, I need to spend a Kennedy.
You're not going to faint or anything.
Oh, God,
right?
No.
Oh, right.
I'm sorry. I hope my husband's watching. Okay.
Marvin said, I just married a school teacher, and you know what? On our honeymoon, she gave me a blank.
She gave him an oral exam.
Right.
Number one, it says here that you're, you operate a multiple spindle automatic screw machine.
Okay.
What do you make?
$2.68 an hour.
Huh?
$2.68 an hour.
We asked 100 women, name something women borrow from each other. Chris.
One another's husbands.
Their husbands, Chris.
Right, let's begin the game. Round one is a fingers on buzzers round, or to be more precise, it's a fingers in buzzers round. Gentlemen, if you'd like to remove the covers. Right, in front of you, you've got your buzzers. If you think you know the answer to a question, simply set off the mousetrap with your fingers and hold it up in the air. Then I'll say your name and you can answer the question. It's quite simple, isn't it?
You may lose the feeling in your fingers during this, but that's a good thing because it really hurts.
Let's begin. First question. What noise does a cat traditionally make? I think Hannah got in there first.
Meow.
Meow, correct. Who is the agony aunt for the Sun newspaper?
Ah!
Name part of the telephone.
The bottom part.
Hey, did you hear that Ronald McDonald Has his picture in Playgirl magazine?
No.
Yeah, let me tell you about it. They got a great shot of his blank.
Quarter pounder.
Quarter pounder.
Obviously, Felice doesn't know Ronald McDonald well. It's his Big Mac.
His Big Mac.
This next series of clips is from Child's Play. Take a look.
This is Darren Eastman. He's 5 years old, and he is defining the word honeymoon. Darren?
Might go to a special hotel. Or maybe out to dinner and then back to the hotel. Then go swimming, and then we could go out to the movies, swimming in the hotel, and go out to the movies, come back, get in bed, listen to the radio for a little while, and read our inquiries or something.
Nothing green and red and purple. They have spots. They speak in a different language. Some have an eye in the middle of their face. Some have noses. Some are nice and some are nasty. Most of them are nasty.
Like, it's something like, the boss says that you're fired. You can't work here anymore. Never come back. And or sometimes when you quit, you say, I don't want to work here anymore. I want to be gone. I don't want to work here anymore. But if the boss says you must stay, you have to keep on saying what you want to say to him. And sometimes your friends, like, they keep on telling you, I want you to stay. But you always say to them, I want to be gone. I want to go away from here. I don't like it. I just don't like it.
I've got lots of books about it, and it's very exciting. Sometimes, though, when I read these books about them, and if I stop off in a very exciting place, I get all nervous and worried. So I have to read on until I come to a nice part of the book.
On the classic game show, Beat the Clock, contestants perform wild physical stunts in a short amount of time. These two contestants are going to recreate a stunt from an episode of Beat the Clock. This is Teen, this lovely young woman, and this lovely young man is Andrew. Now, as you can see, this board, this very ordinary board, is not quite so ordinary because it has two balloons on it. You hold this, please, Andrew. Now, what I'm going to do is ask you, when I say go, to inflate these balloons one at a time. You, meanwhile, lovely young teen, you're going to take this blindfold. We're going to put it over your lovely young face and over your lovely little eyes. And we're going to take this. This is a cork. It's a garden variety cork, only it's not quite garden variety because it has a very sharp pin at the end of it. We're going to put it in your mouth. We're going to put it so the pin is sticking away from your mouth. And if you'll open your lovely mouth, please, thank you very much. Now, what we're going to do is you are going to blow up these balloons, and you, lovely teen, are going to pop them with this. And if you pop them in under 45 seconds, both these balloons, you're going to win this amazing prize.
Then it's a package of Little Debbie Honey Buns. Touched with a delectable blend of cinnamon and a glaze of icing, Little Debbie Honey Buns. It's a guaranteed treat for any breakfast.
I think I was traveling recently in Oman. I saw Little Debbie Honey Buns on pay-per-view in my hotel, but I could be wrong. Anyway, all right, let's put 45 seconds on the clock. You start blowing up your balloons. I'm going to guide you a little bit, teen. Okay, ready, go. All right, you fly up. Beautifully done. Beautifully done, team. Beautifully done. Beautifully done, Andrew. Now, let's see. What do they get? Oh, yes. My gosh. Oh, which Beautiful. Of you is going to get these, or are you going to share them?
Yeah.
We'll share.
Yeah.
Share.
Yeah. 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 Very good. You've done beautifully.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now, here's Chuck Woolery once again with the number two host screw up.
The number two host screw-up was made by me, okay? I was the host of Scrabble, and we used to tape these shows, like Christmas shows and Easter shows and all these different shows, a little ahead of time. And I had this one, well, you'll see what happens. I got this totally screwed up.
Did you get what you wanted for Christmas?
No, considering I'm Jewish.
Oh. Give us one for... skim over that, but I gotta give it. That was good. That was good, Jason. Yeah. Well, what'd you get for Hanukkah?
Nothing yet. It's not that time of the year yet,
Chuck. Oh, good.
Of course, that was one of those rare screw-ups that I have. I do it occasionally. Coming up, the number one host screw-up of all time. Stick around.
Coming up, a match game answer just too filthy to reveal.
It's part of the game.
And find out why this whammy contestant's pointing at her own whammies. Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
As we know, there's nothing more bananas than when a game show contestant means to say one thing and says something entirely different. Witness the hilarity.
What O is the generic word for any living animal or plant, including bacteria and viruses?
Orgasm. Oh.
If you like that, check out these moments.
Name an animal with three letters in its name. You said frog. Our survey said zero. A brand of gasoline we wanted. You said regular. That's a good brand. Our survey said something that comes with a summer storm. You gave me the answer. Snow. Our survey said go on back there. Here's Bob. I'm going to ask you the same questions I asked the other Bob. You cannot and you do not want to duplicate his answers. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name an animal with three letters in its name.
Alligator.
Okay. You don't use narcotics, do you, Bob?
No, but I
mean,
will.
I thought frog was bad. I thought frog was a disastrous answer until you came up with alligator.
Name an occasion when it will be noticed if you arrive late. God, blimey, I needed a shave after that. That's what they call a... what they call a pregnant pose, isn't it? Pam, what do you suggest?
A funeral.
Oh, we treat you well on this show. Stroganoff. Stroganoff, dig in and enjoy. All righty, now, let's meet the person who specializes in unusual dishes. And this is the way the affidavit says. It says, I, Terry Arnell, maintain that meat prices are much too high. Fortunately, I've hit on an ingenious, money-saving, palate-pleasing plan. Every meal, from breakfast through dinner, contains the same basic ingredient.
Yeah.
Take, for example, my glorious beef stroganoff, which the panel is eating now. It is the thrifty shopper's delight. Not only is the meat in my stroganoff healthy and delicious, but also very reasonable in price.
Get out of here, what is it?
Why? Because it's dog food. Oh,
okay, Robin, Who here do you think of your fellow contestants has written a musical?
The one at the end.
The one on the end?
Stuart.
Stuart, yes, that's his name, yeah. You're absolutely right, it is Stuart. Hi, Stuart. Stuart, I've got reasonably powerful gaydar. I'll be honest with you. I'll be honest, it's gone off the map.
Jerry, let's go to you. You need some money for tattoos and piercings.
Yeah.
How many do you currently have of each?
Well, I have two tattoos and one piercing, and I want two more.
At the Cannibal Halloween party, instead of bobbing for apples, they bob for...
Built like I am.
I don't believe it.
I figured they would bob for boobs.
Oh! That's very funny.
Okay, Jerry.
She doesn't want to show hers to
and
see.
And she really shouldn't
have
to.
I'll show mine. I don't think she should show her.
But it's not a match.
No, no, no.
Trust us.
It's not a match.
We have to show it. It's part of the game.
No, I know why she doesn't want to.
Jerry, I'm having a Halloween party on the... Okay, before we go, the moment you've been waiting for, here's Chuck Woolery with the number one game show screw-up of all time.
The number one host screw-up of all time occurred on Match Game. Now, Gene Rayburn is trying to say one thing, but he ends up saying another. It's a classic Freudian slip. Take a look.
We have to introduce another player, and with a great deal of pleasure, we present Karen Lesko. Hi, Karen.
Hi.
You know John?
Yes, we do.
Doesn't she have pretty nipples, pretty dimples there, John? This lady has very pretty dimples in her cheeks, doesn't she?
Well, I hope you enjoyed our top five host screw-ups, and I'll see you next time. Here you go, Ben. Back to you.
Thank you, Chuck. I'm not sure whether to be upset or relieved I didn't make the list. Oh, well, hope you all dug this installment of Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Bye-bye.
Mr. Game Show. Brace yourself for some true game show madness because you're about to see some of the funniest.
Something you squeeze.
Peanut butter.
Most embarrassing.
Before you answer a question, you do a little wee.
I'm not doing it.
Yeah, you are.
No.
Weirdest.
I have a boyfriend named Peck.
Peck?
Yes, as in Peckerhead.
And most disturbing moments on television.
Can we have a look at your tongue? Blimey.
Wow.
So get ready for more fun than a Jeopardy marathon. The most awesome highlights from game show history. Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. And now, here's your host, the man whose money everybody loves to win, Mr. Ben Stein.
Thank you, Mr. Game Show. From the bells and buzzers to the lovely parting gift, people around the world love game shows. We're about to show you the funniest game show moments of all time. And as a host myself, I know how unintentionally hilarious the shows can be. But that... You're wonderful. God bless you. But then again, hosting a show does have its upside. Take a look.
Hello, darling.
Oh. Oh, my goodness.
Thank you. Thank
you're welcome.
Stavroula.
No. Stavroula.
Come here. Stavroula. Do you know, can you understand why they have wars in Greece? I can't understand. Is that... Thank you, Doc. See,
I...
Yes.
I love you.
We must get on with the game.
Yes.
Well, I tell you honestly, we've been on the air, I think, a year and a half. That's right. The first time on those introductions I've ever gotten aroused. Now, we, no, I'm leveling with you. That's the most passionate kissing. I usually kiss for luck, but I got involved a couple of times there.
If you like that, check out these moments.
Milk is the answer that Myron's looking for. Let's see if we get a little milk from Patty here, then.
I beg your pardon.
To a room for room service.
Yeah.
But you didn't take up the offer, no. Chuck. Now, why is that?
Well, no, there's no more ink left in my pen.
And you have $1 left. You win the car. You can buy the car. Just hand it to me from clear over there. Just hand me the dollar. Hand me the dollar. Don't get too close. All right. Goodbye, Julia. Oh, I tell you, she has a glint. No, Julia,
we asked 100 people to name a game you can play in bed. Steve.
I spy.
Just out of interest, Steve. Something beginning with what letter? W. Window.
That's the one.
I spy.
Yeah! You are psychic.
I haven't tried Betty yet.
I've tried Betty.
You want to sail around the world?
Yeah.
Would you like to do it like Kate Cotty or what?
No.
You don't want to go solo?
No, with friends.
You'd like to go with a crew?
Yep.
Well, maybe you'll find some semen tonight. and number two. Oh, no, you can't. No, you can't.
A pee and a pee.
Oh, I think I'll have to take a pee.
Okay.
Name something you feel before you buy it.
Excited.
Name a tradition associated with Christmas. Debbie.
Hanukkah.
Don't say anything. Nobody say anything.
We asked 100 people to name a place where you wouldn't expect to meet a nun. Janet.
A brothel.
And now it is the time for our top five game show moments. This time we pay homage to the contestants' answers so incredibly dumb they make Paris Hilton look like a rocket scientist. Although I have on the internet seen her handle a rocket of sorts, and she was fantastic. We like to refer to these inane answers as blonde moments. And here to present number five is our very own expert on blonde, Kato Kaelin.
Being part of your special is very special, I guess. Anyway, the number five blonde moment is from the game show I'm With Stupid.
Team three, Mike and Maria, okay? Yeah. You've got landmarks, you're matching landmarks to countries. Here you go, you're picking from the right, Mike. Your time starts now.
India.
Acropolis.
Greece. Italy.
Sydney Opera House.
Nixon resigns. Come on.
1940s.
First man on the moon.
I'm so bad. 1920s.
First man on the moon.
I don't want to say this. 1910.
If you think that was dumb, wait until you see number four, which, for all my blonde brothers and sisters, is this many. Anyways, stick around.
Coming up, hey, those aren't lab testicles, are they? Find out what the sick minds at Distraction have cooked up next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
Hey, everybody, you're watching Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Now, people think being a game show host is easy, but it actually takes years of practice, tons of hair products, and a successful game show host has to know how to make an entrance like Gene Rayburn.
Have a strong command of the English language like Richard Dawson.
The age men start going gray.
A successful host must be light on his feet. And must always keep his composure.
Red.
Well, all I could think of was royal flush. Yeah, but that's where you were wrong. Yeah. Now what? Oh, no. What?
No, we blew it.
Not again. Don't tell me.
What did you do?
That's a clue. I was going to help him get the clue for that word.
But the most important rule of being a game show host is never embarrass a contestant unless it will get a laugh. Take a look.
Do you want one of those, or you want to choose one of your own? What came to your mind?
I don't have any.
You don't have any?
No.
I wouldn't say that.
I knew it!
You missed a shot, right, Mark?
Yeah. Okay.
I knew you'd say that.
No.
Something people take from hotels as a souvenir.
Anne.
The lamps.
The lamps. Experience talking, is it, Anne?
Yeah.
Right, those are lamb's testicles. Every time you get a question right, you pop a lamb's testicle in your mouth. First question. Get your coat, love. Ryan?
You're pulled.
You're right. Pop a lamb's testicle in your mouth. Yeah, choose a favourite. Next question. Do you come, Ryan?
Here often.
Yes, you are right. Pop another testicle in your mouth. Imagine this is going to look lovely, isn't it, with two in. If either of you find one with a cyst, you get a bonus point. Next one. Is that a gun in your pocket? Ryan.
You're just pleased to see me.
Sorry, what was that again, Ryan?
You're just pleased to see me.
I did hear the first time, but it is fun. OK, yeah, no, that's correct, Ryan. Pop another testicle in your mouth. And you know, you've got more lamb's bollocks in you than a lamb.
Now here are some more moments from The Dumb and the Restless.
Blank, Tennessee. What do you say?
I say Mississippi.
Mississippi is a state!
Name a state with good skiing.
Florida.
What would be the ideal everyday temperature? Everybody, disrobe. 98.6. Survey said, Dale. It's like living on the equator.
Something you'd find in an operating room. You said, operator. Well, someone's got to operate.
Name a state that begins with the letter M.
Mexico.
We asked 100 people to name a famous author. Kenny.
Shakespeare.
Arthur Shakespeare.
You did. You're a bad. And you know what? You still sleep with one leg off.
Now,
the bed?
Now wait, just a moment. Now,
you said that.
Now, you watched me on Truth, ever since I was on Truth or Consequence.
Yeah, and
what did I say about my leg?
You said you slept with the leg off the bed.
That's... You know,
you
I still
did.
I did, so I probably
you
did.
Bet.
I sleep with 1 foot out from under
well,
the cover.
I don't know, but that's what you said.
Yeah.
That's all.
I sleep with 1 foot out from under the covers, and I always have, and I still am.
Wow, that's what I didn't know.
And I have a boyfriend named Peck.
Peck?
Yes, as in Peckerhead.
We asked 100 people to name something you wouldn't try even once.
Matthew.
Sex on a train.
Sex on a train. No! Funnily enough, our survey people didn't come up with that one.
One of my favorite game shows of all time was the stunt show Beat the Clock. It was sort of like Fear Factor, only no scorpions. Now, to play our show today, we have a wonderful fellow named D. Charles Bartholomew. How are you, young sir?
I am good. Very nice to meet you.
Now, how'd you get that name? D. Bart is your
yes.
nickname, right?
Yes.
And how'd you get that?
Well, my last name is Bartholomew, which is amazingly long and hard to spell when you're in kindergarten. Or
I see. So you adopted D. Bart.
Exactly. It's easier for everyone. It just makes it easier for everyone.
So you are a film student at USC Film
yes.
School. That's yes. a very high-end job.
Yes. Yes.
And what is your ambition?
Ideally, I want to direct game shows.
You're kidding.
Sweet irony, huh?
Excellent. Very, very good. That's a very poorly paid yeah. job, but I hope you enjoy it a lot. Okay, this stunt is from a 1956 episode of Beat the Clock. If you can complete this stunt, and it's a fun one in time, you're going to get this memorable prize from game show history. Mr. Game Show, lay it on us.
Okay, Ben, that's Preparation H medicated wipes. They're 4 times larger than medicated pads and easier for you to cleanse, cool, and soothe.
See, we had the choice of the Bentley convertible or the Preparation H. We decided on the Preparation H. Sounds like a party. Now, for this stunt, you're going to need an inflatable doll, this lovely punching gorilla named Bobo. But instead of punching Bobo, you're going to be pushing Bobo up out of your trench coat without the use of your hands as quickly as you can. You'll have to do it in under 45 seconds. And now here it is. Could you try to please insert
yes.
it under
yes.
your coat, please?
There we go.
Well, let me help you a little bit. Now, I do not want nothing in the Inquirer about that. Okay, so as I said, you have 45 seconds. So please put 45 seconds on the clock. Sorry for spritzing you. 45 seconds on the clock. Ready, set, go, D-Bart. That reminds me of me on a good morning. Anyway, here are your Preparation H medicated wipes. Not just wipes, but medicated wipes. So we're very proud of you, D. Bart. Your
Thank
future
you
is assured. Anyway, now let's go back to Cato Kaelin for the number 4 blonde moment in game show history.
Number 4 is from an episode of the British game show, Family Fortunes.
Something you keep in a garden shed.
A gardener.
I don't get it. Well, I've got more blonde moments coming up, so stick around.
Coming up, find out what big rested beauty this kid's describing of child's play.
I bet she can float on the water easily, but she will never find her dress size.
And what's more fun than a relay race? A naked relay race.
Oh, my God.
Next on Game Show Moments, God Bananas.
There's nothing I like better than 80s game shows. All the members-only jackets and turned-up collars, fantastic. This next clip is from a 1983 episode of Child's Play, featuring Michael Jackson. Oh, no. Oh, that's not it. The show featured children describing words that the contestants would try to guess, but the frankness of the kids could be downright hilarious. Take a look.
Everybody knows what the word is now except our two players. Here's Nikki Simpson, a New Jerseyite little girl. Nikki, dear, the word, please.
It's a person. They ain't fat. They're not in the between, but they're like a very, very small, like... Very small.
Would you like to be that way?
I don't know. It depends on what kind. Like, it depends, like maybe, like, this kind, that, but not this kind.
Well, it's the exact opposite of fat. And you get to be that way if you eat health foods and you don't eat that much too. And see, the exact opposite of that.
My brother is. My mother isn't. She's sort of. I bet she can float on the water easily, but she will never find her dress size.
Do you like being on this program?
Yeah.
Do you know who I am?
No.
You think I'm good looking?
Yeah.
I think you're good looking.
Yes, indeed.
Speaking of good looking, you got a girl?
Huh?
Do you have a girl?
Yeah, girlfriend.
You have a girlfriend?
Three of them.
Three?
But they're older than me. They're older than me. That's why I get the older ones, because they're more mature, and they got money and stuff.
you get the older ones, because they're more mature.
Yeah, and they got more money.
More money, yeah. How much older are they than you?
Well, one of them 30. Yeah. Well, I think one of them is 36, and I think the other one is 37. I have to ask my daddy over again, because I think I know one of them age is 30. That's the only one I know whose age is right.
But your daddy knows how old they are.
Yeah.
How's he know?
Because he's been seeing them for a long time.
If you like that, check out these moments.
Whose nickname is Commando?
Commando would probably be Jermaine.
Why do you think he'd be called Commando?
Don't know, really. Because I just don't think the girls are really commandos, are they?
I'll tell you what, we'll explain it to you later.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, Commando, as in, yeah. No, probably... Oh, my God, I've forgotten your name.
She's got a name tag on, Ryan.
We asked 100 people to name something people have more than two of on their body. Eddie.
Arms.
More than two arms you've got, have you, Eddie?
At Sir Irving's knighting, the Queen slipped with her sword, so instead of being knighted, Sir Irving was blanked.
Bar mitzvah.
Name something you buy and then have to be careful about how you carry it home.
An infant.
An infant. Something you buy.
Oh, buy!
Name something a man has that he'd be upset if someone else used it.
How about his jockstrap?
Use my jockstrap.
Got some fine company here. I want to be
Yes, thank you.
Who you got here?
Okay, this is my daughter, Linda.
Linda.
Welcome. Nice to meet you.
My granddaughter, Cheryl.
Hi, Cheryl.
And my grandson, Brett.
Brett, hi. Welcome.
And my daughter-in-law, don't tell me. Susie.
You got it.
Something usually done only once a week.
Make love.
You stud. No wonder you look miserable once a week.
Hasta 38 kilómetros enfundado en este elegante traje de piel con protección en hombros, codos y rodillas.
Name something London is famous for.
I'm thinking pasta.
Can we have a look at your top? Blimey.
Wow. Hang on. Oh, my Lord!
I think June's suddenly shown interest. Go on. Stick it out again. That is enormous. Do you know, I wondered why she was with you.
Round three. Bring on the laboratories. Tom, if you want to jump into a cubicle.
I'm not winning on TV.
Yeah, you are.
No.
Well, jump in. Don't worry, I put little vanity doors on there so to hide your modesty. Jump into the cubicle. Close the little doors. OK, now, what we're giving away this evening is a £10,000 mini.
I'm not doing it.
But this end game is a little bit tricky. What you have to do is, if you think you know the answer to a question, you've got to do a little wee. And that sets off the buzzer. Just let a little bit out, just a little wee.
No, I'm not.
So, sort of pants down, and then we're away. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, give them some encouragement.
This has got me. Where's Jeremy Beagle? This is ridiculous.
Down, there. Steph.
Oh my God.
Give her a big round. Okay, first question. The subject is water. Complete the phrase, water off a duck's. Steph! Steph, you just done a little wee. What is it?
Duck's back.
Correct. Well done. You did a little wee, you got 1 point. Round of applause. Okay, next question. Which female trio had a hit with the song Waterfalls? TLC, you're absolutely right. OK, which classic film featured a killer great white shark? Steph.
Jaws.
You've won it, Steph. You've won the shark.
I can't believe I won it.
And now here's the gorgeous Kato Kaelin once again with the number three blonde game show moment of all time.
Number three is from an episode of Blockbusters. Now, the lady in the clip is supposed to answer the question that starts with the letter U.
What U are the Eastern Europeans who originated the tradition of painting Easter eggs? Maria.
Yugoslavians?
No. No.
Oh, no. Shoot.
Yeah.
That's funny. Everyone knows Yugoslavia begins with a Y, just like Ukraine. Stick around.
Coming up, the worst Price is Right contestant ever.
You're pretty and you're sweet, but you just have no talent at all for this game. For this game, I said, for this game.
And find out how ex-NBA star Brian Shaw answered this loaded question.
Name something a teenage boy can do for hours at a time.
More filthy fun next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
You know, game shows are enjoyed around the world, from Bangkok to Bangor. Because of the worldwide popularity of game shows, a movement is underway to stage an international game show, Summer Games, featuring such exciting events as the 100-meter flash.
Oh, bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. Okay. Oh, you nearly bombed him at the end there. Hang on, the wheelbarrow.
There will be floor exercises.
Wendy, come on in and sign in, please.
Are you all right? Are you okay?
Yes, yes.
I was just gonna go safe.
And, of course, there'll be a synchronized stupidity event.
Any questions such as, how old are you? Yeah?
18.
No.
I'm not 18.
You're not?
No.
You certainly fooled me. Just a second. I'm going to read the question. Name questions such as, how old are you, that you might answer with a lie?
I would say 50. Did I understand it right?
No, sweet Elizabeth.
I didn't understand.
Give me another sort of question that you might lie about.
I would say I'm 39.
If you like that one, you'll love these other madcap moments.
You've heard the question. Who would you give the $100 to? The taxi driver, the police department, or to yourself?
Did you say Phyllis?
Yes, I did.
Oh.
What? Is that the answer?
Answers. Apart from doors, we asked 100 people to name something that people open. Sam.
Window.
Open a window. Windows, yes. Bank account we had and it wasn't there. Roz?
Bowels. Bowels.
Moving swiftly on, Liz.
Now, wait a minute. I don't think you understand this game. No, the way you play, someone could be hurt badly. Possibly me. Now, what you do is you roll it. You see, down the alley, you roll it, and then it'll go up. You don't just whack that way, you understand? Now, try rolling, rolling. She's the first contestant who ever got two practice throws, I think, on The Price is Right.
Thank you.
I'm only doing it out of self-preservation here.
Thanks, yeah.
You know, you may be the least athletic human being I have ever met. What?
You make me feel really
bad. No, don't feel bad. You're pretty and you're sweet, but you just have no talent at all for this game. For this game, I said, for this game. I just don't know what to do. I hit my shin on this thing. I knew I'd get hurt. There's a wire across here. Oh, that hurt. Oh, you do it yourself. I don't care.
I understand that at one time you wanted to become a mortician.
Yes. Yes. I did.
Why?
He made me quit, my husband. No, but it was a good reason why he made me quit.
Why?
Well, he didn't appreciate my sense of humor. I put an ear in his lunch one time because we got in an argument and...
to name a non-living object which has feet. Caroline.
Plant.
A plant.
Are you familiar with our scorekeeping system?
Yes, I am.
All right, then we'll let everybody except the panel know exactly what your line is.
Now, this product you manufacture, is that sold? Would you be apt to find this in the living room or the dining room or the kitchen?
Well, you can't answer that question.
Well, she must make something. A woman can't make a living just being a blonde. Although I've heard of a few who have.
Miss Grable, when you deal with people, do you touch them?
Yes.
Do you touch them above the waist?
Yes.
For how much?
Are people happier or better off because of what you do?
I would think so.
Sometimes. Now, would you say that you deal with more sex, more with one? He made me do it.
You think I'm the only one that's obsessed with that subject, huh?
When these people come to you and are touched, do they remain fully clothed while you're doing it?
I quit. I quit. I threw in the towel.
Name a piece of clothing wives buy for their husbands.
Halter tops.
I know when my wife bought me my very first halter top, I think I can honestly look back now and say that's where our relationship started to drift apart.
Okay, what do you say we play a little Family Feud?
Yeah,
how does
yeah,
that
yeah,
sound?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Now, your name is Nina Harris, and you are a wedding singer.
Yeah.
Really? You don't look the slightest bit like Adam Sandler, but anyway. Are there divorce singers? We
divorce
sang at divorces, because that's when people are really happy.
We sang at some weddings that we knew were going to end in divorce.
And you also sang at Al Gore's going away party in Washington as he was leaving office, correct?
Yeah, yeah.
What did you sing, Mr. Roboto? Now, we're going to play the feud. Here's how we play the feud. I'm going to ask you a series of five questions from actual feud surveys. I will award you points based on how many people in the survey gave your answer. If you get a total of 100 points or more, you will win this fabulous prize. Get ready.
That's right, Ben. It's kitty litter. 14 pounds of Scoop Away clean cat litter. Scoop Away has maximum clumping action, so odor and mess are easily removed with just a simple scoop.
Excellent. I love the way you say clumping action. Anyway, all right, Nina, let's play the feud. Here is your first question. Get ready. Your first question. Name something you might accidentally leave on all night.
The light.
Very good. The light. The survey said 23. That's great. Okay. Let's see what the actual contestants said.
Name something you might accidentally leave on all night.
Yes.
Your shoes.
I hope you won't take this the wrong way, Kenneth, but you are weird.
Okay, next question. Name something a woman out on a date would hate to discover on her face.
A piece of food.
Very, very good. Good guess. Survey said 35. 35.
All right.
Let's find out what our contestants said.
Name something a woman out on a date would hate to discover on her face.
A booger.
Okay, next question. Next question. Name something that has to warm up before you use it.
Your iron.
Very, very excellent one. Survey says 21. That's very good. Let's see what the contestant said.
Something that has to warm up before you use it, sir.
How about your wife?
All right, next question. Next question. Name something you wouldn't want the police to find in the trunk of your car.
A dead body.
Oh. Survey says 11. Very, very good. Let's see what the contestant said.
Name something you wouldn't want the police to find in the trunk of your car.
Pickles.
Very good, very good. Excellent, excellent. Okay, last question, Nina. Last question. Name something a teenage boy can do for hours at a time.
Play video games.
Very good. Now you're going to be happy about this. You're going to be happy about this because you needed only 10 points to win, and you got 24, so you win. Just for fun, let's see what the actual contestant said.
Name something a teenage boy can do for hours at a time.
Masturbate.
Now you know why I wear glasses. Thank you so much for playing, Nina. You've been a great sport. Thank you very, very much. Thank you. Now here's Kato Kaelin with the number 2 blonde game show moment of all time.
Whoa, I just got a whammy there. The number 2 blonde moment is from Pressure Luck. Oh, there he goes again. That little guy, I'm gonna get him.
According to the lines of a popular song, if I can make it there, I'd make it anywhere. What city are we talking about? Jimmy?
Phoenix.
Now, I don't want to reveal the game show that gave us the number 1 blonde moment. Let's just say that it contains the words,
Family and Feud. Okay? Stick around if you want to find out what that is.
Coming up, distraction host Jimmy Carr talks about his favorite fan letters.
I get about 10 a day saying, do you want to have a penis enlargement?
And another fabulous question from the dirty minds at Family Feud.
Name something that gets hard when it gets cold.
Next on Game Show Moments, God Bananas.
You are watching Game Show Moments, Gone Bananas. I think the motto of this next contestant was, if at first you don't succeed, fail, fail again. Take a look.
Name something people take with them to the beach.
Turkey.
The first thing you buy in a supermarket.
Turkey.
A food often stuffed.
Turkey.
From the side-splitting comedy of that moment, we move on to these little gems.
Name something that gets hard when it gets cold.
Sal. Ice cream.
Ice cream! Something that gets hard when it gets cold.
Cheese.
Something hard cheese. Report.
You asked 100 people to name a game you could play in the bath.
Annette.
Scuba diving.
From a very wealthy family, you've got that big a bath.
A food that makes noise when you eat it.
Really loud hamburger.
Did he say it in time, Judge? He said a really loud hamburger.
So I decided when I was 18 to have a nose job, really.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, have you considered anything else, you know? Maybe a tummy tuck or a
No.
I'm just saying, you know, some areas. Yeah, it's fine. I get emails every day asking me if I want to have a penis enlargement. I presume I'm not the only one. I get about 10 a day saying, do you want to have a penis enlargement? 8 of them from my girlfriend. It's the 2 from my mum that really hurt.
A good pet for an apartment.
Cat.
Something you squeeze.
Peanut butter.
Sorry. You're very weird, honey. Man of the world, traveled all over the world. Something Russia's famous for, Bob.
Russians.
Hundred married men, specifically, something that your wife would do that would be shocking.
Greet you at the door naked.
Good answer. You can keep your cats and never cook either. If you greet me at the door, naked. What? Naked?
What a girl should know about a man before she marries him. You just got it, Lynn. What would you say?
His name.
His what?
Name.
His name. Wouldn't it, in the back of a cart? With whom am I having the pleasure?
How are you doing?
Good to have you here, sir.
Good to be here.
What do couples do to spark up their marriage?
How about get together with other couples?
What do you mean?
What do I mean? I just mean that, not talk. But.
And now it is the moment you've all been waiting for. Kato Kaelin with the number one blonde moment.
The number one blonde moment is from Family Feud.
Darling, what do you think? A product is designed to wear out in a certain period of time.
An iron.
An appliance? I thought so. All appliances are up there. See with the word appliance up there?
That's not an appliance?
It's, yeah, it is. An iron?
Yes, an iron.
It's an appliance.
Well, I thought so.
Yeah. So give me another answer.
Oh, all right, I'll give you another answer.
Yeah, yeah.
Freezer?
No, all appliances. That'd be like your blenders and your toasters, your coffee pots and your can openers, your microwave ovens, I guess, your stoves, yeah. That would all be together, Don.
Oh, I see the appliances is up there. I'm sorry.
That's all right, Don.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. I just don't want you to be confused. Now, we want you to give us a product designed to wear out in a certain period of time.
Tires.
They're up. Time.
I'm trying too hard.
It's all right, Don.
Ben, back to you. Yeah, I said it right.
Thanks to all of you for joining us on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Bye-bye.
Mr. Game Show. Brace yourself for some true game show madness, because you're about to see some of the strangest.
Something twins might share while growing up.
Well, I would say a mother's breast.
Dumbest.
Name something that you can put hot tea into.
Blimp.
Kettle.
A kettle.
Funniest.
Something your neighbor has, if you wish you had.
A beautiful wife.
Most revealing moments on television.
My underwear was falling off.
So get ready for more fun than a sponge bath by Bob Eubanks. It's the most amazing highlights from game show history. Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. And here's your host, Mr. Ben Stein.
Thank you, Mr. Game Show. It seems like game shows have been around forever. They say the first game show was called simply Of Fortune because the wheel hadn't been invented yet. Thank you. I'll be here all week. Try the veal. Even today, certain game show contestants leave the distinct impression that they were raised in a cave. Take a look.
Name an animal whose eggs you'd probably never eat for breakfast.
Hamster.
Hamster. Tell you, but, you know, those little pellets aren't eggs.
We asked 100 people to name something that you can put hot tea into.
Glyn.
Kettle.
A kettle!
What are you gonna do, Sylvia? Are you gonna pass or are you gonna play?
Oh, I'm gonna play.
Okay, good.
Cigar.
Chris, what's your most bizarre sexual experience?
there was a toilet incident.
Sorry, a toilet incident?
Yeah. It's not the one you've got on there, is it?
No.
Okay, first thing's I'm sorry, Mum, I'm sorry, Dad.
You pissed on your mum and dad?
No.
To name something you write about on a holiday postcard.
Oh, we've got to say, send a postcard home.
Wait. I'm afraid I'm going to have to go with it, but what you're writing on a postcard is, dear friends, I'm going to send you a postcard home.
You're a woman. You're flat-chested.
That's two.
You're getting married. Wedding ceremony. You're giving a ring to somebody. You're getting engaged. Oh, it's a Hawaiian. It's a lei. It's a hula.
Okay, switch actors.
It's a ring. It's a wedding ring. Oh, it's a honeymoon.
And now, here to present the top five wardrobe malfunctions in game show history is the renowned fashion expert from America's Next Top Model, Jay Manuel.
You know, pop stars aren't the only ones who suffer from wardrobe malfunctions. Many a game show contestant has too. That's why this week, we're celebrating the top five wardrobe malfunctions, starting with number five, this moment on Family Feud.
Rascal talking to your mom when I came
My
out.
My underwear was falling off.
Huh?
No.
What did you say?
My underwear was falling off.
Excuse me.
My underwear was falling off.
I know, I put the microphone away, honey. Honey, no one will ever hear that. Truly.
Fashion tip number one, don't go on a game show wearing your grandmother's panties unless you're into that sort of thing. Stick around for more fashion flubs and faux pas.
Coming up, Bob Barker fields some frisky advances.
You are the only man I would leave that man for.
Plenty of hot contestant on host action. Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
You are witnessing the magic of Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. If you like this show, then you're going to love our next series of specials, When Game Show Animals Go Bananas and Relieve Themselves on Stage. That's right. That's right. I wasn't kidding you. Here's a sneak peek.
Jerry Curley and Carol Burnett.
Does anybody in the audience want an empty armadillo? Happened to me.
Beth, you have to. I did it. You want to show me how? Show you how.
Be our guest.
Oh, boy.
Why don't you hold it? Take her off. Take her off.
Bring on the pigeons.
Oh, oh my God! God. No way! This is so wrong.
Can I have it, yeah?
No,
I
can't.
She got protection.
Seriously,
how? Protection. No. Let's see. Look.
It's no good screaming. That will make them more. If anything makes pigeons, it is a bit of screaming. They smell.
They smell?
Yeah. They're on you. Of course they smell.
From the side-splitting comedy of that moment, we move on to these little gems.
It's wonderful.
Oh my God! You are not gonna believe this. This is my dream come true. Oh my God!
Well, now, just a moment. Now, Rosina, listen. Rosina, I don't want to shatter.
You are so handsome. Oh my God.
Well, then go ahead, Rosina. I don't want to interrupt you.
You are the only man I would leave that man for.
Go ahead, keep talking, Rosina.
See that man right there?
We'll just do five games today. Listen, Rosina, I must interrupt you for a moment.
I gotta sit down.
But keep that trend of thought.
Okay.
What I started to say is, now, I don't want to shatter your dream.
Oh, you won't shatter nothing of mine.
Well, now Rosina.
Oh! Are you all right? No, don't be embarrassed. What happened was she fell in my hole, you see.
It's so easy to do.
What do you do, Leo?
I'm a captain for a fire department.
Do you have any goofy calls? Do you ever get, like...
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I had a call just a while back where an elderly woman had... She was sitting on the toilet, and she had been reading for quite a while and couldn't get off. And so her daughter had to call us, and we had to go out, and we used KY and tongue depressors to... to peel her off.
Story. Now, the distraction in this round is the fact that your money is burning. There's quite a lot of smoke there. Okay, give him a little bit of support, I think, yeah. Okay, Sam. Lovely. Okay, question number three, Sam. Question number three. Don't fan the flames, you
A slang word for money.
Money.
Name something you wash once a week. Claudia.
Yourself.
Yourself. I will not be coming around.
Name something that comes in sevens. Caroline.
Fingers.
Put me in a Family Feud kind of mood. So what do you say? Let's play the feud. You are Kendall Swenson.
Yes.
Lovely young woman. You are an assistant to a music attorney. Is it possible to sue Yanni for just sucking so bad?
I think it's been tried.
I hope it works. Now, recently you went to a Cubs-Dodgers game at Wrigley Field. You were wearing Dodgers gear and you got beer poured on you. Are you sure it was beer?
I hope so.
It's time to play the feud. It's time to play the feud. I'm going to ask you a series of five questions from actual Family Feud surveys. If your answers total 100 or more points, you will win a phenomenal prize from Game Show history. Here is Mr. Game Show to tell you all about it. Mr. Game Show, if you please, maestro.
It's 7 ounces of Wheat Nut Snack for the crunchy, good, nutty taste without the nuts. It's Wheat Nuts.
I like it. All right, Kendall, here's your first survey question. Real or fictional, name a famous Willie.
Willie Mays.
Excellent, excellent. You said Willie Mays. Survey said 32. Let's see what the original contestant said.
Real or fictional, name a famous Willie.
Willie the Pooh?
Next question. Name a job that helicopters are used for.
Traffic reporting?
You said traffic reporting. Survey said 4. This is what the original contestant said.
A job that helicopters are used for.
Tuna fishing.
Can't blame her. Helicopter caught tuna just tastes better. Okay, next question. Name something most women wouldn't be caught dead leaving the house without.
Their purse.
Very, very good. Very good. I think you nailed that one. You said their purse. Survey said 31. Let's see what the original contestant said.
Name something most women wouldn't be caught dead leaving the house without.
Molly. A tampon.
Good answer. Ew. Next question. Name an invention that has replaced stairs.
Escalator.
Ooh, very smart. You said escalator. Survey said 17. The original contestant said,
name an invention that has replaced stairs.
The wheel.
I spend hours a day on my wheel, Master. That's how I look as good as I do. All right, last question. Name a part of the body that gets bigger as adults get older.
Your ears?
Very good. You said ears. Survey said six. That's not so bad. Not so bad. You lost. You lost. But don't feel bad, because this is what the original contestant said.
Name a part of the body that gets bigger as adults get older. Freddie.
Penis.
If only it were true. Anyway, thanks for playing, Contessa. It's been a pleasure. Thank you, Kevin. You're very kind. Thank you. Thank you. Let's quickly move on to Jay Manuel to present our number four wardrobe malfunction game show history.
When Gary Berghoff of MASH fame appeared on the game show Tattletales, something went missing in action. Here's wardrobe malfunction number four.
A world-renowned sculptor wants to do a full-length sculpture of you to be displayed in a public place. The only requirement is that you'll be absolutely naked. Would you do it? Think about it, fellas. We'll come back for your answers in a moment. Don't say anything.
I'd say no.
You say no. He wouldn't particularly care for that.
I don't think so.
Okay.
But then I don't know. I mean, there's some things, you know.
He doesn't even tell you about, huh?
Right.
All right, but you're going to say that no. You think he'll say no, he wouldn't.
Right.
All right, let's bring him on and find out. Gary.
Gary Berghoff naked? Well, that was something I did not need to see. Stick around. Wardrobe malfunction number three is a true fashion disaster.
Coming up, a new torture scenario for the four contestants on Distraction.
May I just say, you all look fantastic.
Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
This next clip is from the 50s game show. The name's the same. Which celebrity panelist tried to guess the identities of guests with names that were the same as familiar people, places, and objects? The question could be unintentionally hilarious. I guess intentionally hilarious, too. Check out this episode.
Let's let our home audience see this gentleman's famous name. All right, let's start this time with Joni.
A thing. Is it a useful thing?
Yes.
Is it also pleasant to have around the house?
Yes.
I would say that, yes.
Would you say that a man can get pleasure from this, too? Yes.
You would say, yeah. Mm-hmm.
When you press one of these things in the dark, does it light up? No. Are these things fairly soft to the touch?
Well, as a matter of fact, I'd say that, yes.
Yes.
Yes. Very soft to the touch.
Well, do they generally come covered?
Yes.
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 Would you say that they were pleasant to sit on?
I would say they're very pleasant to sit on.
You know, nothing has been said that I can make any sense out of. I've heard a lot of extraneous remarks, but I don't pin you down. All I know is that you have been in the kitchen. And you're allowed elsewhere, and you're soft to touch. I pass before I get arrested.
If you like that, check out these moments.
And now welcome the star of our show, Greg Evans!
an animal with really good sight. And you said, a bat. And I said, he said. Well, that's because they keep crashing into walls and nobody said.
Bat Frida. When she met the Indian chief, she said, I love you, chief, take me. He took one look at her and said, blank.
Oh, wait, I didn't finish. If the camera came on now, it's going to spoil the effect of a lighter.
Okay,
so I want to speak to the director and the producer because I am not ready.
Follow me with the camera. Follow me with the take two or four, three. I don't care anything. Get off of one. Do what I tell you to. It's my show. When I say get off of one, I mean get off of one. Get off. Get off. I say move that camera. I say move that camera. Get that camera. Get that camera! He hit me! He hit me with that camera! Get out of here!
You've written on your form that your ex-boyfriend that you now live with sometimes pays you for sex.
Used to.
That's amazing. What did you charge him, Emma?
40 quid.
40 quid?
Yeah.
I'll be honest, form an orderly queue after the show. That is... I bet we could get a group rate, eh?
We surveyed 100 people and asked them to name a way of toasting someone. Michelle.
Over a fire.
Yeah, that's all right, no. I'll tell you what. If it's up there, I'll give you the money myself. Over a fire. Oh, no! £12. That's the first time that's ever happened.
Something twins might share while growing up.
You know, I can't help but think that they both feed from the same place, so I would say a mother's breast.
While growing up. Right. They're 25. Hey, Mike, are you still with Mom?
100 people surveyed in all our games. We asked 100 people to name a character from Alice in Wonderland. Alan.
The Tin Man.
The Tin Man. Alice and her little dog, Toto.
If he went off and tried to kiss a man, you wouldn't mind?
No, not at all.
I'm not bisexual, so it sort of doesn't have the benefits for me, does it?
I think you should go out and get your revenge on her.
I don't really like kissing men.
You don't really like
you
kissing men?
You have done, though.
Well, what... you don't mind drinking other men's pee.
Hang on a second.
Yeah.
Just one sec.
One sec.
I don't want to interrupt you in the middle of something.
Yes.
He has kissed a man.
Yes, he has. Quite a few.
No.
Preferably the entire Queen Mary rugby team.
See, that's where it's all right.
Sorry, because they throw a ball to each other.
You know, it's like comedy kissing. You're like,
no.
You're not quite sure.
Comedy kissing.
What's comedy kissing?
I could show you on Jimmy, but...
Go on, then.
Yeah. Go on. Yeah. Walk over, eh? Good for me. I think you like that.
Right.
June, right. June, I don't want to be unpleasant, but that tasted of piss.
Let's take a look at our next top five moment.
When Playboy playmate Tawny Cable appeared on Family Feud, she was involved in a boob incident that couldn't be blamed on Justin Timberlake. Here it is, wardrobe malfunction number three.
Good luck. Thank you, Christoph.
You're the host. I am kidding. Here you go.
You know, the first time anybody's ever slapped that buzzer and didn't use their hands. I need an answer. I probably need two.
Stick around for wardrobe malfunction number two. It's so 5 minutes from now.
Coming up, a Playboy Playmate's revealing response on Family Feud.
Lost my virginity.
Find out what the question was next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
Show Moments Gone Bananas. Now my friend Chuck Woolery will forever be associated in people's minds with the game show Love Connection. But I've developed my own set of Love Connection rules based on the techniques of other game show hosts. Rule number one, always make a good first impression.
Number two, make your intentions clear.
Sylvia Anderson, do you like to play password?
I love it.
Would you like to do it? We're all ready to do it. Here, I mean, play password, that is.
And number three, get hot contestants to tell you dirty secrets.
An occasion for which you stayed up all night.
God,
Three seconds.
Lost my virginity.
You're gonna steal.
It took all night.
I'd have been there to take it all week.
Very smooth. I'm gonna go try out my romantic techniques on some of the ladies here, because frankly, this play I got mad skills. In the meantime, here's more totally bananas game show moments.
Name a specific food with an edible skin.
Peach.
A peach. A banana.
Well, it's a food with an edible skin.
It is, yep.
Why, you gotta
feel it. It took you about 81 hours to get it down, but... I mean, even monkeys peel, have you noticed?
Why, sure. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'd like to ask you why just the new girls on the block get the kiss. I'm a new girl. How come I don't get one?
Oh.
That's one thing you forgot to tell us about you when I said tell us a story of your life. You didn't tell me you liked to kiss.
Well, there's no woman going to get kissed by handsome men except here.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
No for me. This is going to be a straight kiss.
Yeah,
no fancy stuff.
Right.
Not. Yeah, no. All right.
Something your neighbor has you wish you had?
A beautiful wife.
Al, beautiful wife. Gene, check the papers next couple of days. See if well-known glass manufacturer is killed.
Name something with a hole in the middle. Michelle?
Hole punch.
I know everyone in America said what the audience did. What she say? Come over here for a second, Michelle. Just lean in. Hello?
I'm embarrassed.
Hello? McFly?
Something that you jump on and ride. What do you think?
Your partner.
Thank you.
I forgot.
Yeah. You became much more interesting when you... Oh, look at you, Shay.
I'm all right.
Now, just stay right up here. There, I want... Now. Well, that's amazing. Oh, you are you doing that deliberately?
What do you think?
Well, I don't get mad. I was just... What?
Oh!
Yes, that's what I thought you said. But can't you stop them from doing that?
Just go on and I'll try.
All right.
This next clip is from a 1983 episode of Child's Play. This could be downright hilarious. Take a look.
It's Kimberly Zorns, 8 years old, from Nashville. Kimberly's defining the word ponytail.
Oh, Mommy often says, do you want your hair up? And I say, no, because I don't want it up. And she says, Kimberly, you have to have it up so I can see the ticks if they get up there on your head.
Well, there are people like Mario Cuomo and Mayor Koch and Ronald Reagan. But I don't think they could be the Muppet Show. And people like George Burns, because they're very serious. Whoops. It means that you're not exactly old, but then you're not exactly you.
Oh,
and you're so happy because of something you did or something you could have did or something that you didn't do that you shouldn't have did or something that you did that you should have did that you did and you're glad you did.
Well, there are two of them, and one of them is, oh, no, my turkey is beep. And there's another one that is a child. If the turkey one was, then you'd have to probably cook the whole thing over. Mm-hmm. And if the child is that, then it's bad because you can't do the whole thing over.
Thank you, Devin Rattray.
The madness continues with this clip from Family Feud.
What one bad habit do you have that you'd most like to lose? Roy.
Picking my nose.
We asked 100 people to name a place where you would keep a pen. Marie.
Zoo.
You want to write something, so you're going to go down to the zoo to get your pen.
Top 10, event, an Olympic.
What are gymnastics?
Did you say what are gymnastics? This is not Jeopardy. But we still love Jeopardy with all our heart, I'll tell you. All right, is it Jeopardy? Oh, no, is it gymnastics?
84,241 pesos en premios. Contento, amigo. Contento, feliz. Qué bueno, David. Que disfrutes tus premios. Ay, ya se nos cayeron por allá.
We're ready to go with the next question, and here it is. I have the ladies out here with me, as you can no doubt. No, I have the fellas out here with me.
A reason for kneeling. Ian.
Church less.
When you go to church, to pray is the top answer.
Mark.
To be beheaded.
OK, now, the aim of the game is to get as many elastic bands on your face between those two blue elastic bands as possible. I'll be asking you questions throughout. Put elastic bands on your faces. What D is another term for stupid? Tom.
Dumb.
Yes, correct. What D is Homer Simpson's catchphrase? Christine.
Duh. Doe. Doe.
Correct. Name a breed of dog beginning with D. Debbie.
Dalmatian.
Correct. What D roamed the Earth in the Jurassic period? Tom.
Dinosaur.
Correct. A man can be hung like this animal, and you can ride one on Blackpool Beach. Debbie.
Wonky.
And now it's time for a little more fun with our studio audience. We're going to recreate... I don't know if I'd be smiling if I were you. We're going to recreate a famous beat-the-clock stunt with these two volunteers, Lisa and Sean. Now, Lisa, lovely woman over here, you are from where?
New York, originally.
And you are a karate instructor.
Yes, I am.
Excellent. And you used to be a dancer at Studio 54.
Yes.
So if people got out of control, you could clock them, knock
exactly.
them down.
Exactly.
Did you see a lot of misbehavior there?
I tried not to see it. I was
very,
young.
Very so. Sensitive.
Turned
no
away.
Evil. Now, I have a black belt, too. It came with these pants. Now, you, young sir, Sean Scarborough, where are you from?
Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
And what do you do down there?
I'm a VIP coordinator.
And what is VIP? Who's a VIP?
Like you, I would take care of you if we went somewhere, or if you were at a party, a function, I would make sure you were all good.
Now, do you know a VIP named Carrot Top?
Yes.
You think you can get me his autograph?
I'll work on it.
Okay. Now, you recently hurt yourself. You slipped and you dislocated your shoulder while you were on a 65-foot yacht trying to get off the yacht. So what happened to the boat?
It sank.
You're kidding.
No, it's gone.
Well, how did the owner feel about that?
Not too happy, I guess, but I think it was insured.
I see. Okay. So, but how'd you dislocate your shoulder?
Literally sliding down the deck to get into the dinghy. I caught the side of it. My body went down, pulled my arm out.
Dangerous thing to be playing with a dinghy at your age. Now, we are going to do a nice little trick. You two stand facing each other, put your hands in your pockets like that, and then like that on the other side. And when I say go, here's the fun part. When I say go,
you are going to try to remove both jackets, both these lovely windbreaker jackets, without taking your hands out of your pockets. If you can do that in 45 seconds, you're going to win this fantastic prize. Mr. Game Show, lay it on us.
I will indeed, Ben. It's Philips Milk of Magnesia. Doctor recommended Philips Milk of Magnesia does not contain harsh stimulants that can cause pain and cramping. Use as directed, Ben.
Makes a great chaser, too. Okay, guys, now let's put 45 seconds on the clock.
All right, you ready?
It's the 45 seconds on the clock.
We can do it.
Ready? Go!
All right, come on. Wait, come on, you can do it.
The clock, and so you get this Philips Milk of Magnesia. Which of you is going to take it home?
I think I need it.
Okay, well, you're going to get it. This gives me an idea to win Ben Stein's Milk of Magnesia, a very lavish prize that many people in my age group need. Okay, now once again, here's fashion expert Jay Manuel with the number two wardrobe malfunction game show history.
The number two wardrobe malfunction happened on The Price is Right. Come on down and take a look.
Sandra Hallisey. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
I beg your pardon? I think I heard what you said. Yes. And the way you are clutching yourself, I think I know I heard what you said. Did you arrive in contestant's row and say, I broke my bra? Is that what you did? Okay. Did something else slip then?
Coming up, the number one wardrobe malfunction in game show history. Trust me, you don't want to miss this.
Coming up, another titillating question for the bawdy Match Game crew to tackle.
Being married to a drill sergeant has its drawbacks. Every time we make love, he expects me to.
Hear the panel's answers next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
But we still got some flavor to drop on you. Check out these moments.
The police commissioner said, I think Batman and Robin are blank.
Queer.
Wouldn't you know, the moment I got my Robin outfit, a rumor like that would start.
Name something you like which is bad for you.
Sex?
You're doing it wrong, you know.
No one's all got four kids.
He's got big ears, hasn't he? Somewhere to rest your ankles, ladies. What's the matter with that? In this game, your buzzers are mousetraps. If you think you know the answer, just set off the mousetrap with the tips of your fingers, hold it up next to your face, I'll call your name, you'll answer the question, you'll get a point. Can you all just, before we start, go like that? OK, that's lovely. It's just you might not be able to afterwards. Right, if anyone severs their finger during this round, we do have a pack of frozen peas in the wings. I know it's not much of a consolation prize, but... You may lose the feeling in your fingers during this, but that's a good thing, because it really hurts. OK, first question. What M is a black and white bird notorious for stealing? Claire.
Magpie.
Magpie, you're exactly right. What M is another word for insane? Simon.
Mad.
Well done, you got that one. What M is the Virgin Mary or the Queen of Pop? Claire.
Mary.
Madonna. No, it's actually Madonna.
Okay.
Pretty close there with Mary. What is an automatic weapon of rapid continuous fire? Sonny was the
machine gun.
Well done, Sonny. Name an English Premier football team beginning with the letter M. Jax? No, you're wrong. Give me a type of cheese beginning with the letter M.
Ow.
Claire.
Mouldy cheese.
Mouldy cheese? I will accept that desperate guess.
Thank you.
Right, you all did extremely well. You got almost twice as many questions right as the mice in rehearsals. Jax, you were last. That means you're going home, I'm afraid.
Aww.
Never mind, she f***ing lost.
Name something besides soap and a towel that people take with them to the bath.
A duck.
An occupation that uses... Stop the clock, please. Here we go. Come on. I did this once before. I don't want to break up. Ready?
No.
Everybody ready? Duck. I said to Karen, she'll do it. And then you gave me duck. I can't believe that. Something people take with them to the bath besides soap and towel. Survey's up. I have to retire after the show. Something you make conversation about when you meet a stranger.
How about maybe mutual friends? Someone you might...
I got you. Well,
I don't know.
I don't think I've ever seen you before. How's Harry? Who's Harry? My friend. Judy, I love you, but you're funny.
I believe you're a gymnast.
Yes, I was, yeah, up until about 18.
Is it good going out with a gymnast?
It's the best.
Yeah. See, the reason I'd like to date a gymnast is the way they do that lovely flip and jump when they dismount.
Susan said, being married to a drill sergeant has its drawbacks. Every time we make love, he expects me to blank. Do push-ups. Do push-ups. All right. Push-ups. Every time we make love, he expects me to what?
The push-ups are the man's job. It's the woman's job to sound off.
Sound off!
Salute.
Salute. Another good answer. What do you say, Georgie?
I said, stand at attention.
Yes! Being married to a drill sergeant has its drawbacks. Every time we make love, he expects me to
clean his weapon.
And finally, the moment you've all been waiting for. Here's Jay Manuel with the number one game show wardrobe malfunction.
Every self-respecting fashionista knows how important it is to accessorize. The number one wardrobe malfunction involves an accessory worn by Rip Taylor on Super Password.
Testimony.
Perfect clue.
Well, that's the top five wardrobe malfunctions. Thanks, Ben. I had a fashion fabulous time.
Thank you, Jay, and thanks to all of you for joining us on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Remember, it doesn't matter whether you win or lose, as long as you get a lovely parting gift. Bye.
Bye.
Mr. Game Show. Brace yourself for some true game show madness, because you're about to see some of the dumbest...
Something you call can have two of.
Paula.
Wheels.
Weirdest. Funniest.
Name something normally worn only by children. Michael.
Clothes.
And most shocking moments on television. So get ready for more fun than a day of antiquing with Paul Lynde. It's the most awesome highlights from game show history. Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. And here's your host, the man who proves that, yes, people with larger heads are smarter, Ben Stein.
Thank you again, Mr. Game Show, for that wonderful backhanded compliment. Hello, everybody. We're about to show you the most hilarious moments in game show history because the only thing more fun than solving game show clues is watching clueless contestants. Take a look.
Any part of the body beginning with the letter N?
Knee.
Name a noisy bird.
Chipmunk.
We asked 100 people to name a famous robber. Joe.
Cops. And robber. Sorry, no, wrong. Cops and robber.
A farm animal that people have as a pet.
Turkey.
How many?
That's your spot. Now wait a minute. You can't trade. You get back over there. You where you were over there, Danielle. You Emma, you just got here and already have everything screwed up down there. Emma, stop frightening my beauties that way.
Besides Bond, name any character from a James Bond movie.
In every James Bond movie, he always has a number one lady. And I think her name was Julie.
Okay, Rose, good answer. Good answer.
Julie? No.
Come on, Joni. Come on, Joni.
Any character from a James Bond movie? No,
because it's Carol.
Carol.
Yes.
No.
Password is eats.
Okay, Phyllis.
Masticates.
Fornicates.
That's it.
Just when you thought it couldn't get any funnier, here's some more game show brilliance.
In round two, all you've got to do is identify celebrities by looking at the little screens in front of you. Quite simple. Obviously, it's not quite as simple as that. If you could just pop in your cheek retractors. We got these from a skip outside Elton John's house, so apologies if they smell a bit musky. It's quite simple. Do take into account the effect that the bubbles will have.
Hello.
Bubbles. Turn on the machines. The distraction in this round will be the bubbles will be firing into your faces throughout the game. Look at Chris's little face. Don't worry about bubbles coming in your face. You can do your own Michael Jackson joke there.
Nothing adds sparkle and glamour to a game show like celebrities. Here to introduce the top five celebrity moments in game show history is the man who went searching for stars when he wasn't introducing them on The Tonight Show, the great Ed McMahon.
You know, game shows like What's My Line, Hollywood Squares, Match Game have boasted more Hollywood stars than Tinseltown's famous Walk of Fame. Now, some of those moments have been more memorable than others. Here now is a young man on a game show called Password Plus.
All right, Carson, first clue is yours.
Bosoms.
Bust.
Second clue.
Tube.
Oh, boy, oh, boy.
What'd you say?
I said, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Can we accept
Why
that?
Why bosoms and tubes are my... Oh, never mind.
Flang.
Oh, no.
Celebrity moment number four features a total unknown who went on to become a sitcom superstar. Stick around and find out who that is.
Coming up, what did this woman do to earn the wrath of Mr. Bob Barker?
That's the dirtiest trick anyone ever pulled on me.
Find out next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
You are being amused and entertained by Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. You know, being a student of both game shows and popular music, it's amazing how many of these moments remind me of hit songs. For instance, this next one made me think of Hit Me Baby One More Time.
The answer is...
Yes! I'm sorry! Are you okay?
I think she broke my hair, Judge.
And this password clip recalled another big Britney hit, Oops, I Did It Again.
The password is crank.
Yours, Jack, 10 points.
Crank.
Yes. 7 points, Jack.
Crew.
That's a great clue, Jack.
You know, I meant to tell you I also cheat.
How about this one, conjuring the 60s classic, The Sound of Silence?
Name an animal whose legs are featured on a restaurant menu.
And finally, dude looks like a lady.
Time is up, ladies. I mean,
Now, here's a Family Feud contestant who's got her musicians a little mixed up.
Name your favorite male country western singer of all time.
Van Waylon.
Van Waylon.
The madness continues with this clip from The Price is Right.
Higher.
Right you are, you get a chip, put it by one of the chefs. No! That's the dirtiest trick anyone ever pulled on me. Now, wait a minute. Do you mean to tell me that after picking that up and looking under there and seeing that there's no ball there, you're going to put the chip beside that shell?
I laid it down.
That's dumb. Don't do that. You cheated and got away with it. Now, don't put the chip by that shell because, you see, you looked under there. There's no ball there. So, obviously, it's by one of those. Now, move it. All right. Where are you going to put... Oh, you're going to put that there. You know, I'm pretty sure she's won this. Didn't win it with that one, did she? Didn't win it with that one, did she? Boy, this is exciting now, isn't it? You know, you've ruined my game. This would be exciting, but everybody knows the damn thing's not there. It's here. You win. Congratulations.
Name a city in the state of Georgia.
Alabama.
Pardon?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Alabama.
Ideal man, Ken the Dolly?
Yeah.
So your ideal man is 7 inches long and made of plastic?
Debbie, what do you think? Something people close?
Legs.
Name a sport husbands and wives can play together. You said kickball! You know, you're not usually married in third grade.
Name a game that uses a black ball.
Ken.
Hockey.
Bridget.
Darts.
Name something normally worn only by children. Michael.
Clothes.
Anyone could do better than those contestants. A fact we're about to prove as we play our own version of Family Feud. This is the lovely Kayla Miranda.
Yes.
You are an assistant to a music attorney.
Yes, I am.
And is it or is it not illegal to download Lil' Kim?
I think it's illegal.
Okay,
but
I'm not going to do
it. Because of why you think.
I'm not going to do it anymore then. Okay. I'm going to ask you a series of 5 questions from actual Family Feud surveys. If your answers total 100 or more points, you'll win this cool prize.
Then it's a tube of Super Polygrip denture adhesive. Now featuring an ooze control tip. Get the confidence you need with a strong, long hold of Super Polygrip.
Oh, my God. I wish I had ooze control. Oh, God. I would have really liked to have had it when I was young. Anyway, all right, Kayla, here's your first survey question. Name a type of bear.
Koala.
Very good. You said koala. Survey said 24. Excellent. Here's what an actual Feud contestant said. Type of bear.
Name a kind of bear. Harmon.
Papa bear.
A papa bear, of course.
Okay, next question. Name a real person who made a living scaring people.
Ronald Reagan.
Okay, you said Ronald Reagan. Survey said 0. Here's what a Feud contestant said.
Name a real person who made a living scaring people.
Red Skeleton.
That's great.
That's too scary. Now, next question. Name something that falls from the trees.
Leaves.
That sounds perfect. You said leaves. Survey said 38. The Feud contestant said this.
You're gonna have the bank if they can't tell me something that falls from the trees, Jackie.
About bird.
Next question. Name a department in a supermarket.
Produce.
Very excellent. You said produce. Survey said 23. An actual contestant said this.
A department in a supermarket.
Lingerie.
I am obviously going to the wrong supermarket. Anyway, last question. Describe the weather with a word or phrase that could also describe your wife.
Cold.
Okay, you said cold. Survey said 20. Congratulations, Kayla, you win. You win, congratulations. And this is yours. I hope you can make a lot of use of it. Your answer is so much better than this actual contestant's.
Describe the weather with a word or phrase that would also describe your wife.
Wet.
Wet.
I don't think I'm even gonna touch that. I don't wanna touch that. Wait a minute. That didn't come out right either. Anyway, thanks for playing, Kayla. Thank you very, very much. You've been wonderful. Thank you very much. Now, let's move on to Ed McMahon and another top 5 celebrity moment from game show history.
Celebrity moment number 4 features a beautiful interior decorator from the Midwest. Take a look.
And this lady is from
Wichita, Kansas.
Very good. Wichita, Kansas. And she's an interior designer.
That's right.
I'll begin. Harriet said,
who?
I'm worried about my husband. He keeps bringing home leftovers from work. The only trouble is he works in a blank.
Hospital.
In a hospital.
Of course, as we all know, Kirstie Alley went on to become a star. Coming up, person who became one of the most famous men in all the world. So stick around.
Coming up, another sick twist from the producers of Distraction, Electric Shock.
What is the largest land mammal that never forgets?
Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
Game with me. Young madam, would you like to play a little match game with me?
Sure.
Please stand up. And what is your name, please?
Jill.
And what is your occupation, please?
I'm a trade show hostess.
Well, then maybe you should tell me what you'll win.
I don't know.
Okay.
A carpet to stand on at the next trade show so my feet won't hurt.
Excellent prize. A carpet. Very good. Maybe a remainder carpet. In a moment, I'm going to read you a phrase with a blank in it. Before the show, I wrote down my answer on this sacred card. If you can match it, you'll win this fantastic prize.
Then it's Poppycock, original gourmet popcorn, featuring savory mouthfuls of popcorn, glaze, and nutty goodness. It's Poppycock. Don't even try to resist.
Okay, Jill, here's the phrase. Bowl blank. What's your answer? Bowl blank. What's your answer?
Okay, I'm going to keep it clean.
Okay.
Pen.
Oh, good answer. You could have said Bull Durham, Bullfighter, Bullhorn, but you said Bull Pen. This is what I wrote down. So you won the poppycock. Congratulations. A big day, Jill. Very good, very good. This next moment is from that classic game show, Tattletales. The show tested how much celebrities and their significant others knew about each other. In this clip, host Bert Convy, the one and only, played an April Fool's prank on comedian Toadie Fields. Let's take a little look.
What is your husband's full name? Think about that, ladies. We'll come back in a moment for your answer. There they go. Okay, I gotta tell you something, fellas. This is April Fool's Day, and what we want you to do is make up a phony name. Okay. So that when the ladies come on the air and give the answer thinking they know it, you'll groan like they got it wrong, and we'll say, I'm sorry, that's not it. Okay? Okay. So we
make up a name?
You make up a name. We'll start with you, Georgie. So make up a name.
Aloysius. Aloysius is a very nice
George
name.
George Aloysius.
George Aloysius Johnston Jr.
Junior. No, okay, let's bring her on now. All right, Toadie, what is George's full name?
You know the name. Tell him
George William Johnston Jr.
No.
Toadie.
I'm so sorry, Toadie.
What happened to Aloysius? You forgot Aloysius?
Where the hell is Aloysius? There is no Aloysius. Aloysius?
You know Aloysius.
I would marry a guy whose name was Aloysius. Johnston was bad enough.
What?
My father threw up at that.
What? You forgot Aloysius.
Honey, your name is not Aloysius. Where did you get Aloysius?
Toadie.
Your mother would do something like that, too.
From the side-splitting comedy of that moment, we move on to these little gems.
Name? A specific part of the body that women try to accentuate. Saber.
Breasts.
We asked 100 people to name something your car can have two of. Paula.
Wheels.
Isn't that called a bike?
Is there a product involved in what you do?
Yes.
Is it a useful product?
Oh, yes.
I wonder if the product that you deal in can be taken internally.
Yes.
It can. Is it some kind of a tablet or pill?
Yep.
I know what it is already.
What? Gary?
You want me to help?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
She makes diet pills.
Florence has asked me to advise you, Mr. Lewis, that she has lost 40 pounds.
Name something that comes in pairs. Fred.
Bananas. Oh, God.
Bananas. Let me see bananas. Something that comes in pairs. Helen.
Lovebirds.
Lovebirds. You both need help. Show me lovebirds. Not there. You buzzed in first. Terry, a chance for you to help your family. Something that comes in pairs.
Children.
Children? Show me children.
In this first game, we asked 100 people to name something you associate with the sea.
Ron. Deck chairs.
What's that out at sea? Where she blows that deck chair. Ron wants to see a deck chair. This is so Pat.
Coffin. Coffee.
Coffin. Coffin.
A coffin.
Yeah.
At sea, you mean, Pat, yeah? Yeah. Oh, you're thinking of the letter C.
Yeah.
S-E-A, I meant.
And the first thing you take off after work?
Underwear.
The next question, what time do you get off of work?
Now, traditionally, in a game show, you press your buzzer and you answer a question. There's nothing the matter with that. It's simple and effective. But on distraction, when you press your buzzer, you will get electrocuted. OK, you've all been wired up before the show. Now, don't be nervous, because if you get nervous, you'll sweat. And if you sweat, you'll get wet. And if you get wet, this is a lot more dangerous. First question. A bird in the hand...
Oh, two in a bush, man!
OK, correct comic. Give me a boy's name beginning with the letter E. Joe.
Edward.
What is the largest land mammal that never forgets? Jermaine.
Elephant.
Correct. When the cat's away.
Run. Michael Jane.
A bird of prey beginning with E.
Eagle.
This next clip is from a 1983 episode of Child's Play. Take a look.
We have Frank Burns. He's 5 years old, is old Frank, and he's from Pennsylvania. And just for you, Frank is going to define the word baby. Frank.
This thing is starts out as an egg, and then when it first looks a little human, it's like about the size of a shrimp. And then it gets bigger, and it's like inside this wet balloon.
Would you like to be one of these again?
No, wait. Because if I was these one again, then I would have to do this my whole life over again, and I've had some pretty rough times.
I ride to her. Dear Nancy, how's things going back into Hunga? How's your day been going? And how about a date with me sometime when you get older? And I'd write love, Sean. And then I'd write to another one named Kimberly Arnold. I'd write to her this very same thing. See, I'd take a copy of the letter I wrote to Nancy.
It's something that you get movement on, and you snap your fingers and you clap your hands on it, and you sing from off of it.
Could you give me a demonstration?
No.
No? Mm. Let me try.
I don't know what demonstration means.
Thank you.
And now, here is everyone's favorite sidekick, Ed McMahon, with the next top five celebrity moment from game show history.
Celebrity moment number three involves an actor who went on to bigger and better things after this appearance on What's My Line?
Well, judging from the applause, I take it that you are a performer. Of a performer. Would you consider yourself a leading man?
Rather.
And have you appeared in pictures?
Yeah.
Have you done serious dramatic parts in pictures?
Oh, yeah.
Are you Ronald Reagan?
Ronald Reagan, right. Ronald Reagan went on to appear in that great game show, What's My Line Item Veto? Just a little joke. Very little. Up next, a revealing moment from a Hollywood superstar.
Coming up, a very hairy Alex Trebek delivers a very naughty clue on Double Dare.
The more horizontal this thing is kept while in action, the more likely you'll get what you're after.
Find out when Game Show Moments Gone Bananas returns.
This is Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. You know, swearing on game shows is a time-honored and, in my humble opinion, awesome tradition. Here are some of the most memorable potty mouth moments.
Come across number two. This is Darren Stewart. Here comes Darren Stewart. You turned him down as well. Darren is raving. Thank you, Darren. Come across and meet your date, contestant number two. He loves traveling. He likes playing guitar and motorbikes. Kim Hopkins, please meet Darren Stewart. Who is Darren, you or him?
I'm Darren, you. That's Rhett.
That's Rhett. Yes. You're Darren. Okay, stand right there and...
Tell me a slang term that means wife.
Bitch.
Oh! Oh, good answer!
And Angie, what about Dad? Was he proud of his little girl?
Yep, I got a bonus in my, Und der 1 befindet sich der 15-Mark-Bonus.
Und wenn auch Sie mal als Kandidat hier ins Studio kommen möchten, no, I'm wrong!
I like keeping the censors on their toes. You never know when I'm gonna bust out with an F-bomb. This next series of clips features people who weren't obscene. They were just so wrong.
Ball? Don't you dare. Don't you dare. I know you're too long. I don't want you to do that.
Frog?
50-50 tie. Our champion and our challenger. As we go to this subject, it is a thing, and here is the first clue. The more horizontal this thing is kept while in action, the more likely you'll get what you're after. Number two. In the film Walkabout, the lead male straps one against his thigh with his loincloth. Next clue. To use one properly, grip it firmly with three fingers at the curve near the tip. Number four. If yours weighs more than 8 ounces, don't expect it to arc back after you've used it. John?
A boomerang.
You're right. You take the lead. You go to $100.
You've got a sister, haven't you?
Yeah, twin.
A twin sister?
Yeah.
Brilliant. And what does she do?
She's a nurse as well.
Wow. Two twins? Both nurses?
Yeah.
I know what the men are thinking. If only they were good looking. I'm joking, of course. You're lovely. Have you ever, you know...
We do snog occasionally when we're out.
Do you?
Yeah.
Brilliant. That's lesbian and incestuous.
Okay.
Right.
Well, you did fine. What happened? The one that you came a crapper on, a cropper on.
Gee, I didn't think it was that bad.
Now here are some more moments from The Dumb and the Restless.
I asked you the birthday that men dread the most. You said their wives.
Rachel.
Let me think. Oh, boy. Oh.
Yeah.
What is the lowest, please?
I beg your pardon?
The lowest.
$125.
Okay, $126.
$126. Very good. All right, the actual retail price is $250, and Rachel has won it. Who was that?
A polite word or phrase people use to curse. Rachel.
Booger.
That's very polite, Rachel.
Yeah.
I'm Danny. Sophie, if you'd like to remove those covers, we'll get on with round two. In front of you, there is a bowl of snails. Actually, they're trying to escape, aren't they?
Yeah.
In this round, when you buzz in and answer a question correctly, you get to pop one of these snails in your mouth.
With the shells on, yeah?
Yeah, without the shells on, they're slugs, aren't they? The questions in this round are, appropriately enough, about the French. Of course, this game wouldn't work in France. They'd be so busy talking loudly and pompously, they wouldn't hear the questions. What part of the frog do the French eat? Darren.
Legs.
Correct. Pop a snail in your mouth. Ironically, Darren, snails don't have a mouth.
What?
Just three that they empty when they panic. Frenchie is a pink lady in which 1970s musical? Sophie.
Grease.
Correct. Thought you'd know that, Darren. Where in France would you find the Arc de Triomphe? Darren.
Paris.
Which river runs through Paris? Sophie.
Seine.
Correct. Name one of the original Three Musketeers. Danny.
Poncho.
Sorry, Poncho. I think that's one of the fellas from Chips.
You know, friends, in the movies, they hire stuntmen to do the crazy stunts. On game shows, we just use ordinary human beings, and they do it for free just to be on TV. We're going to recreate one of those crazy stunts from the classic game show, Beat the Clock, with these two lovely people who foolishly volunteered, Stacy and Todd. Now, Stacy, you are from where?
Walmerada.
And you are a criminal justice student, correct?
Correct.
And what do you want to be when you get out of school?
I have no idea.
Maybe a detective, go around and beat people up and extort information out of them.
Maybe something like
Excellent.
That.
Excellent. Very, very good. Now, you, young man, have something very interesting going on in your life, which I am very jealous of. This is Todd Marshall. You are the punter for the Sacramento State football team, correct?
Yes, I am.
Very good. Very good. Hey. You and I have a little bit in common because I was quarterback for the Yale Law School debate team. Anyway, now, all right, Stacy and Todd, here is your challenge. Are you ready?
Ready.
Stand
ready.
Facing each other. Okay, now I am going to place a balloon. First, you have to have your hands on your back, as you do. I'm going to place a balloon between you two, and the object is for you to bust these balloons by bumping into each other as hard as you can within the bounds of decency. And if you can bust 44 balloons in 45 seconds, you win this incredible prize, Mr. Game Show. What is it?
Ben, it's a bottle of Gold Bond Original Body Powder. It absorbs moisture and stops the itch and pain while soothing your skin. More than a powder, it's a medication.
So its name is Bond. Gold Bond. Okay, now, contestants, let's put 45 seconds on the clock. Get ready to bust some balloons. Okay, gang, go! Oh, very good. You did that very, very well. Here is your prize, your Gold Bond medicated pen. Well, wait a minute. What if she wanted it?
We can share it.
Okay, that's very, very nice. Okay, here's Ed McMahon with the number two celebrity moment from game show history. Go for it, Ed.
The number two celebrity moment features an actress who's been called America's sweetheart. But in an early appearance on Tattletales, with one of her As the World Turns co-stars, she showed a slightly edgier side.
You're visiting neighbors and you see a high-powered telescope on their terrace. You ask what they look at through the telescope and they say, mostly the neighbors. You are one of the neighbors. Would you ask them to stop looking at you, yes or no? Meg, what would you do about the
Do you know this is a true-to-life situation? Isn't it horrible? But there is a man across the street who looks... He has a telescope and everything. Honest to God. Anyway, what I did was I bought shades and I painted an obscene symbol on the other side.
Yeah, and boy... And let me tell you how angry I am about it, too.
Way to go, Meg. Coming up next, our number one celebrity moment features a television legend.
Coming up, everyone's favorite game show attraction, Naked Old People. Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
We've got a few more delicious morsels for you on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. The most memorable moments in game shows are those that are exciting, dramatic, or just plain weird. I think these next moments fall in the latter category, but I'll let you be the judge.
Name something you keep handy near your front door.
A spittoon.
In this round, I'm going to be asking you simple questions, the answers to which are all numbers. You have to go and fetch the number, and then you have to bring it back and put it on your board, okay? Yeah. Bring in the numbers. It's like something out of Dawn of the Dead. The numbers are placed on and about ugly, old, naked people. You have to retrieve them with your teeth and put them on your boards. It's amazing how far you can let your body go without actually dying. OK, let's begin. First question. How many times has Tim Henman won Wimbledon? Oh. Come on, quick. OK, next question. On average, how much sperm is contained in a male ejaculate? With your teeth. Yeah, that's it. With your teeth. Quick. Oh, Jesus, wet. OK, lovely. Lee, I'm guessing you're firing blanks, are you? In bingo, what number represents two fat ladies? OK, come on. Oh, yeah. OK. Anna, you took your time, didn't you?
I got my head stuck on my
It's not something you hear in every show.
If you like that one, you'll love these other madcap moments.
Name a kind of attraction you see in almost every parade.
Merry-go-round.
A merry-go-round.
Match the words from column A with the ones from column B, okay? It's how many in there. It's matching an item with the number of items in it. Your time starts now.
Years in a decade.
144.
How was coming out? That's normally quite a traumatic thing. Was it all right?
I sort of fancied this girl in my class who was sat across from me in chemistry lesson. I thought, ooh, she looks really pretty. I'd like to kiss her. And I thought, oh, that's not normal. I must be a lesbian. So then I told everybody.
I'm a lesbian?
Yeah, and I never went back.
So you told everybody
did you,
at school?
Did you raise your hand or did you just shout it out? Are you sure there's nothing that could ever sort of, you know, sway you back?
No.
Is there any man that could make you think, I'll tell you what, I'm going back on solids?
No, I don't think so.
We asked 100 people to name something you stroke.
You stroke a match.
Stroke a match, do you? Yes. Come on! Come on! You're my favourite match!
Jane Dunham! Come on down! Yes, Jane, it is you! That's it. That's it. TMF. Yep. That's it. Yep. You'll get it. Perfect, man. You, Jane.
Now...
Oh, my God.
What's up? Are you OK?
Yep.
Jane, it's really... It's just a game.
My kids won't believe this.
Yeah, they will, because they'll be watching on the television, Jane.
Oh,
Jane, you're going to make your kids... Don't cry. Please don't cry. Our prize, 510 ladies. Would you step this way with me?
Pearl, maybe you want to step on the other side here. Now, Pearl, has she always been an emotional sort of lady?
Occasionally, yes.
Oh, Jane, don't cry.
These stunts are going to look there.
560. Light it up! Jane, I tell you what. Hang on a sec, hang on. I tell you what, I'm gonna get into so much trouble for this. I'm going to give you that holiday, Jane, because you haven't had a holiday in a long, long time. I'm in trouble, but I think you deserve a holiday. You go away and you have a lovely time.
Thanks.
All right? You're going to love it. You have a lovely time on holidays, all right? That's from everybody at Channel 9 and The Price is Right. And, of course, the Gold Coast International. Thank you very much. You'll love that, Jane, all right? Congratulations. All right. We'll be back after this on The Price.
I know you've been waiting for this. Here's Ed McMahon with the number one celebrity moment in the history of game shows.
The number one celebrity moment features a man who started out as host of game shows Earn Your Vacation and Who Do You Trust, then went on to become the king of late night. Here's Johnny.
Your partner, this very bright guy, Johnny Carson, here is going to give you clues to 5 passwords, one at a time, and every password that you get is worth $50. Here's the first word. Go.
Scared.
Afraid.
That's right.
Mafia.
Gangster.
Automobile.
Car.
Hat.
What's the hand? Sorry.
Chauffeur?
Forget it. Next word. Booze.
Liquor?
Olive.
Martini.
That's 100.
Yes.
No?
30 seconds.
tonight. And.
All right. 20 seconds.
Forget it.
Thanks for all the laughs, Johnny.
Thanks, Ed, and thanks to all of you for joining us. Hope you enjoyed Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Bye-bye.
Mr. Game Show. Brace yourself for some true game show madness because you're about to see some of the noisiest, oddest.
If I had a pin right now, I'd go help him.
Funniest.
Name something edible that women use on their hair.
Hairspray.
And craziest moments on television.
Fancy Jim, he's a boy.
Okay,
I'm young.
You take your hands away from your vagina.
So get ready for more fun than playing Strip Jeopardy. It's the most awesome highlights from game show history on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. And here's your host, the guy voted Metz's sexiest man alive, Ben Stein.
Thanks, Mr. Game Show, and you're the hottest puppet I know. Now, viewers around the world love game shows. In fact, some people claim game shows are better than sex. At least you know it'll last a full half hour and there'll always be applause at the end. But in either case, if someone starts laughing, you know you're doing something wrong.
Name something people do when they say goodbye. Linda.
Leave.
One of the three bears.
Yogi.
This man is flying airplanes for us.
nickname, an article of clothing a woman might borrow from a man.
Underpants.
Slang word for money. Eva.
Bitch.
Pardon? Bitch? What's a bitch for money? Mum? No, not mummy.
Oh.
Money.
Who here has had an intimate liaison with a professional footballer?
It has to be Darren.
It actually wasn't Darren. Gemma, it was you, wasn't it?
No.
You said you went out with someone who played for Leighton Orient.
Who told you that?
You did. So, Gemma, what happened?
I was just seeing him. Fancied him. He's a boy.
Okay,
I'm
could
young.
You take your hands away from your vagina? Now, you got revenge on a boyfriend as well. What did you do?
I felt Viagra in his food. It's like, cos, like, he pulled someone behind my back and I'm not a so he took me for so I had to get revenge on him. You know what I'm saying, girls.
OK, so for revenge on a boyfriend that was cheating on you, sleeping with another girl behind your back, you put Viagra in his food.
Yeah.
So if he was going to this other girl, you were going to be sure he was going to do a decent job.
Name an occupation in which you disguise your appearance.
A doctor.
I don't claim to be the smartest man in the world, only like the third or fourth smartest, but even the best and brightest have an occasional mental lapse. So here with the top five brain freeze moments of all time is the woman who's caused the blood to rush out of many a man's head, the most downloaded woman on the internet, Cindy Margolis.
I love a man with brains and money, of course. Our number five moment features celebrity panelist Brett Summers suffering a brain freeze on Match Game.
Tom, what about you? Where are you from?
I'm from down south, a computer programmer for airlines in Atlanta.
What is a Peter programmer?
Computer programmer.
Computer.
I'm sorry.
Tom.
Stick around because Brain Freeze moment number four is coming at you soon.
Coming up, get ready for a barrage of bawdy answers to this Match Game question.
Tarzan came home to find Jane in the arms of another man. He said, "Meet Tarzan. You."
Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
You were basking in Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Right now, I'd like to send a shout-out to my peeps on the technical crew. They work hard to make sure all the props and set pieces function exactly as they're supposed to. Let's take a look.
Tonight's amazing sale of the century jackpot totals $66,000.
This bar is designed as a storage area as well. And when you're ready to serve refreshments, just press the top and presto! From Jules Seltzer and Associates.
Yay!
Somebody
well,
maybe in her case
right.
You'd make an exception.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Is it the Seven Dwarfs?
Is anything working
I said,
there? Are any of you working?
Is it the Seven Dwarfs?
I think they're...
The answer is no. What is that, sir?
That's the end of my cable.
Oh, let me see that. Good throw.
Nice.
This is the end of the cable that would have given us a ding or a meep.
Well, that poor man is at the end of his cable.
He is, yes, and his ding doesn't work either. Okay, here
what
we go.
Moving
right along.
I happen to have here Philip Marsden's pet parakeet. Here in this cage. Now, if we're lucky, when I release Bobby from the cage, he will fly to his master.
Lost me.
And if he takes a piece of my... Get up.
I am petrified.
Come on, get up. Get up. No, don't bite. Get up. That's the boy. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, will you gentlemen all stand up, please?
Oh,
If you like that, check out these moments.
We asked 100 people to name something you borrow from your partner. Leon.
Shoes.
Shoes. Let's have a look for shoes.
A food that comes in instant form.
Oh. Asparagus.
Smiling Jack's secret is that he is going to blow up a standard automobile tire inner tube until it explodes, and he's going to do it with his mouth. I asked him before the show, I said, where do you want to stand? He said, I want to stand out where I'm not near anybody. And I said, why not? He said, because I don't know where I'm going to land. And I said, what do you mean, know where you're going to land? He said, well, it knocks me down. Do that. Don't turn toward me. Turn the other way. Well, I shouldn't laugh. I never saw a man working so hard. And all. If I had a pin right now, I'd go help him.
If that thing backfires, his stomach's going to blow out.
Jack, you feel all right?
Valerie, the big bad wolf said I just came from a house where this old lady had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Boobs.
So shocked, appalled, and outraged by an answer in my entire life.
I bet.
I said, bazooms.
How dare me. Yes, speaking of bazooms, Fanny, would you show us yours?
Well, as I said earlier, the shoe.
When it comes to body language, Match Game was the best blanking show ever. And now we're going to play some Match Game with our friend Kevin Meister. How are you, Kevin?
Pretty good. How are you?
Nice to meet you, sir. You are an internet consultant?
Yes.
And so you're the one who makes sure that when I go onto the online and nothing comes up and for a very long time?
Yeah, in layman's terms, basically.
Excellent. What happens if you plug the internet into the 110-volt socket on the wall? Does the whole internet blow up?
No, just one section, you know, kind of like the blackout in New York.
So one whole section of the internet would go up in smoke?
Yeah, probably.
I wonder why my son hasn't thought of that. Anyway, so you recently had an episode in Las Vegas. You
yes.
were swimming in a pool at a hotel, and?
And I thought I saw a friend of mine, and so I went and flipped her raft over.
And was it your friend?
No.
Who was it?
Biker's wife.
A biker's wife?
Yeah.
So. Okay, how did he react?
Well, he wanted to beat me up. I mean,
did he beat you up?
No, my friends convinced him not to.
Excellent, yeah. Excellent. Well, thank God for that, because now you're here on our show ready to play Match Game. In a moment, I'm going to show you a question from a 1998 episode of Match Game hosted by the great Michael Berger. If your answer matches more stars than the actual contestant matched on the show, you will win this awesome prize.
Then it's a bottle of CLR Cleaner. CLR dissolves tough calcium and lime deposits and surface rust stains from tubs, toilet bowls, sinks, glass, chrome, fiberglass, and stainless steel.
Kevin, here's your question. Tarzan came home to find Jane in the arms of another man. He said, me, Tarzan, you...
Tramp.
That's a good answer. That's a good answer. Let's see what the actual show contestant said.
Tarzan came home to find Jane in the arms of another man. You with me so far?
I'm with you so far.
He said, me, Tarzan. You.
Dead man.
You dead man.
All right, I like that.
Let's see which one of you matches the most celebrities.
Dead.
Yeah. 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 Wow. Woo.
Tramp. Me, Tarzan, you slut.
All right. Me, Tarzan, you what, Nell?
Need a lawyer.
Me, Tarzan, you hoe.
Okay, judges, what do you think? Does he win? Judges? You are in luck. The judge looks like slut and hoe, just as it was tramp. For the record, we also would have accepted skank, whore, bimbo, floozy, trollop, Jezebel. Anyway, congratulations, Kevin. You win. And now, let's take a look at our next top five moment.
Brain freeze moment number 4 comes from the game show Family Feud.
Name a famous resort area outside the continental United States.
Tahoe.
If you thought that was bad, wait till you see brain freeze number 3.
Coming up, the moment that shocked Bob Barker into saying this.
We are in the presence of a miracle.
Find out what happened next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
Yo, yo, yo. Welcome back to the Shizzo. Ben Stein bringing you Game Show Moments Gone Bananas, as only an incurable Caucasian can. Now I'm going to turn things over to my homie, Coolio, who kept it real on Match Game 98. Check it out, biatch.
Susan, here we go. Robbie the Robot said the guy who made me got a lot of parts from a toy store. For example, my eyes are made from marbles, and my blank is a slinky.
Wiener.
My wiener is a slinky.
Wiener! Wiener!
You didn't want to say it. I know, you feel so bad saying that.
Wiener!
Wiener doodle!
I'm a wiener!
Show me the plugged-in answer.
Okay, my Johnson.
Yeah, that's a match. There you go.
My wiener.
Yeah.
My third name.
You got it, you got it.
If you like that, check out these moments.
For you. Now, we know you've got a very famous name. Before we play our game, let's let our home audience see this gentleman's famous name. I think you know how we play our game, panel. Mr. X's name, may I tell you, represents a thing.
Thing. Is this something that I might use?
Yes.
Would I enjoy using it?
Very much.
Could I ever use this in my work?
Now, I think that, yes, there might be an occasion for you to use this in your work.
Is it possible that if I gave a party...
Joni!
You don't think I ever
Joni,
gave a party?
Joni, the answer is no.
On The Prize Is Right.
I thank you very much, and I welcome you to The Price Is Right. Backstage, they have monitors that the fellows on the crew can watch what's going on out here, just like the monitors here. They're just like television sets. When Vanna was invited to come on down, one of them read her T-shirt where it says, Get Serious. And he said, I am.
Mrs. Periwinkle said, it's tough being married. Oh, man, Periwinkle, no matter how hard I try, I can't get a blank out of him.
A rise out of him.
You know, she looks like a little old lady.
Clock will start with your first bid. Go.
193.
Higher.
540.
Higher.
820.
Lower.
700.
Higher.
749.
I'm going to have to sit down and regain my composure after that. I hope you realize we are in the presence of a miracle.
Before you answer a question, you do a little wee. Audience, if you could just look away now, and viewers at home. We're not joking. It is absolutely serious. The prize is amazing this evening. Yeah, they deserve a round of applause. First question. Spell cat.
C-A-T,
that is correct. 1 point to you. What is the plural of the word ball? Robin.
Balls.
Balls. Yes. I imagine yours are getting quite cold about now, aren't they? OK, don't anyone force it. We're not plumb for solids. What's the next number in the sequence? 14, 15, 16...
We've run out.
Stuart's run out of wee. Stuart.
Hello.
The answer.
Oh, which one did you go up to? I was working too hard on the piss. It was either 16 or 17. I can't remember how far you got.
17.
Up to. Thank you.
Is that a little fart I just heard?
I'm saving that for in case there's a special game for it.
This next clip is from a 1983 episode of Child's Play. Take a look.
All right, we're going to have Marty Pritikin, who's 6 years old, from Chicago, defining the word romance. Marty?
That is sickening. It's like that I have to look at. I don't know how to explain this. Promise not to tell anybody. I'm too embarrassed. When somebody falls in love, I don't fully find saying this. And like they kiss or hug.
Well, it means when a man and woman have a nice, delicious dinner, and they go on their date, and the man says, "Let's go out on a date. Come on." I love you. She says, "Come on, let's go," and that's probably before she gets married. She might already be pregnant.
Oh, like, that might be this real cute girl. And she's laying back on the sun. And she lays on her back with a skimpy bathing suit. I mean, skimpy. She may be laying in the front like this. And she might laying on the back like this. Until she gets the sun makes her a little, you know, brownish. Not this girl.
Now, here's our number three brain freeze game show moment.
The number three brain freeze of all time involves Three's Company's Norman Fell.
You know, a scientific institute has created a sperm bank to preserve the genetic heritage of our finest minds. Now, the directors of the institute ask your man to make a donation. Would you mind if he did that? Norma, what will Karen say to this?
Well, I gave it the office, actually. No, I'd give him $100.
What's that?
I'd give him $100.
No, wait a minute. No, this is not that question. No. They've come to you and ask you to donate to the sperm bank for future use. See, it's not money, it's...
Oh, no, not money?
No, there's no money involved here. Nothing changes hands.
Hold on, because you won't believe Brain Freeze moment number two.
Coming up, the contestant business gets a whole lot more dangerous. Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
This is Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. Baseball and game shows are both favorite American pastimes. In fact, former major leaguer and announcer Joe Garagiola went on to host a version of To Tell the Truth. Here's a clip of Joe stepping up to the plate as panelist Bill Cullen commits a little bit of an error.
Bill Cullen.
Well, you know, we have a rule on this show that if we have seen some of the people on the show, whether they're right or wrong, we can question but not vote. Well, I have to disqualify myself because I met one of those gentlemen in the men's room, which...
What does that got to do with this?
Well, I want you to know where I met the man. Because you might...
How do you answer Kitty's question?
How'd you know he was the real one?
He had his bird in his hand.
Joe Garagiola isn't the only sporting type to grace the game show world. Price is Right model Janice Pennington was famous for her incredible curveball.
Here we go.
It's in the hole.
Well, oh, look, look. Wait a minute. What did that hit? What did that hit? What a... I have never seen anything like that before in my life.
Match game panelist George Wallace is the king of the Grand Slams.
George, you know any ugly people?
Yes, I do. I know your mama. I'm not going to talk about your mama because, frankly, I never met the man.
And Richard Dawson always knew when one of his players needed to be relieved.
What's the matter?
I need to whisper something in your ear.
Excuse me a second, play. You want to whisper something?
Oh, uh-huh.
What's wrong? what we should really do is stop the taping at this moment.
Do you just have a can?
No, we know we don't keep the tape in a can. We have a big box. We're gonna pause for just a second. Really, we will be back though. Off you go, quick.
Oh, okay.
Now, here are some contestants who won't ever make any game show all-star team. Check it out.
Is that you laughing? Okay, you better have some water there. You all right? Ready to meet our next contestant, Sean. Thanks for having all this fun with us tonight. We'd love you to come back and sort of sit in the audience for the next couple of nights. Would you do that for us? Thank you.
Show everyone the price of the dinnerware, and audience, do not try to help us. Brian, that clock will start again with your bid on the dinnerware.
$89.
Higher.
105.
Stop the clock. Are you saying $89? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
And then you said $100?
Yeah, I wasn't even saying higher.
Brian, what kind of a show do you think this is?
The clock will start on your opening bid.
200.
Higher.
300.
Higher.
400.
Higher.
500.
Higher.
600.
Higher.
700.
Higher.
800.
Lower.
875.
Lower.
874.
Lower, sweetheart.
700.
Higher.
750.
Higher.
780.
Higher.
800.
Lower.
791.
Lower.
92. 90.
Lower.
789.
Lower.
780. 7.
Higher.
786.
Higher.
788.
Okay, well, we've got two distractions in this next round. One's called Highlander. And one's called Flatliner. Would you like to meet them?
Hello.
I'm trying. I don't know if anyone else is doing this, but I'm looking at you two. I'm trying to. I'm trying to decide who's got the nicest. Because yours are definitely bigger, but he's got some shape in his, hasn't he? Highlander, I don't want to be rude, but your genitals look tiny in that. Now, contestants, you'll each be given 45 seconds to answer as many questions as you can. The distraction is these two reprobates will be picking you up and throwing you around while you're trying to answer. Marsha, if you'd like to step up to the mat. Name three chocolate bars that take their name from space. Marsha, name three chocolate bars that take their name from space.
Mars, Milky Way and Galaxy.
Correct. Marsha, in the children's story, what did the three little pigs build their houses out of?
Straw.
Yeah, straw's one.
Three.
Yeah.
Ah!
Name four types of root vegetable, Rory. Four types of root vegetable.
Carrot, cabbage, radishes.
Sorry?
Carrot, cabbage, and radishes.
Okay, not cabbage. Go on, try another. Come on, Rory.
Carrot, cabbage, and potatoes.
Potatoes, yeah, that'll do. What is 6 times 11?
Me, I don't know.
What is 6 times 11? 6 times 11.
6 times 11? 77, 66.
66, that's correct.
Hang on.
Okay. Okay, what is 5 times 9 plus 8? 53 is right. Spell Italy backwards.
Y-L-A-T-I!
You're absolutely right. Which boy band had a hit with All Rise?
Of people to name something associated with the three bears. Betty.
Red Riding Hood.
Porridge loaves.
Porridge. Let's have a look for porridge. Carly.
Red Riding Hood.
She said that. You never heard that? Well, we've already had it, Charlie. It wasn't there.
What? Porridge.
Porridge. We've had that as well, Charlie. So has Goldilocks, I think.
The woodchopper.
The woodchopper!
In comedy, timing is everything. That was especially true of the great game show Beat the Clock, where contestants had to perform funny stunts before the time ran out. Right now, we're going to recreate a classic Beat the Clock stunt with the help of these two beautiful contestants, the lovely Bonnie and the lovely Stacey. Now,
thank you.
Bonnie. You are a student at Cal State University Northridge.
Yes, I am.
And you're studying liberal studies. That's like how Al Gore invented the internet.
Exactly.
Very good. And you are a karaoke expert.
Oh, yeah.
And you like to do it when you drink.
Oh, yeah.
And which do you like to do more, the karaoke or the drinking?
A little bit of both.
Could we do Disco Inferno sometime together? That's my favorite song. Burn, baby, burn. Excellent. Very, very good. Now, you, Stacey Chambers, are a beautiful housewife, but not desperate, I understand.
Not at all.
Now, you have a wonderful husband.
I have a gorgeous husband.
Very pays a lot of attention to you, if you know what I mean.
Yes.
Excellent. Very good. And you do not have a 17-year-old gardener by any chance.
Not yet.
But is your husband 17?
No.
Okay. Well, times will change. Anyway, now, here's how the game works. When I say go, Bonnie is going to read this list, holding it here, but you can't see it. It's a secret, of 10 famous people from the world of music aloud to Stacey, and Stacey will repeat them back. That doesn't seem so hard, does it? Not quite as easy as it sounds, because before reading each name, Bonnie will stick a marshmallow in her mouth, or maybe I will stick it in her mouth, and every time Stacey guesses correctly, Bonnie will stick another marshmallow in her mouth, or maybe I'll do it for her. And if Stacey guesses all 10 musicians in 60 seconds, you're gonna win this fabulous prize.
It's Barbasol Shaving Gel. Made for any man, Barbasol Gel moisturizes and lubricates even the toughest beards to help give you a clean, close, comfortable shave. Ben.
Okay, now I'm going to go in the middle of you two. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to put the first one in your mouth. Okay, ready? Go!
Britney Spears.
Britney Spears.
Excellent. Next, marshmallow.
Alicia Keys.
Alicia Keys.
Excellent. Next marshmallow.
Connie West.
Very good.
Jessica Simpson.
Very, very good. You're doing great. Excellent. Very good.
Usher.
Very good. Very good. Okay.
Illegally over. Yes. Christina Aguilera. Eddie Prince.
No, no, no. She's trying her best. You're never going to be lonely, honey. Oh, time is up. I'm so sorry, Bonnie. Stacey and Bonnie. Look, I have the refuse tray. You did a very, very good try. Thank you very, very much. You didn't beat the clock. But thank you so, so much for trying. And now you did a great job. You both did a great job. Oh, are you crying? Oh, don't cry.
I tried.
You tried so hard.
It was Maroon 5.
Oh, you did such a good job. Anyway, and now here's Cindy Margolis once again with the number two brain freeze moment from game show history.
Host Lily Savage created quite a stink on the British game show Blankety Blank with this brain freeze moment number two.
Gary Lineker was a great footballer. Was he a footballer?
I think so.
It's just he did adverts for crisps. I'll never forget when he tripped over his feces and what is this? Oh, his laces.
When we return, I'll give you the biggest brain freeze moment of all time. You don't want to miss it.
Coming up, more fun with electric shock on Distraction.
She's not screaming like a girl.
Next on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas.
We are nearing the end of our wild ride on Game Show Moments Gone Bananas. These next moments are from a show called Your Face or Mine, where contestants try to predict who the audience thinks is better looking, their significant other or the person on the video screen. What a cruel show. Wow. Check it out.
I think me.
Yeah.
Let's have a look, see if the audience agree. Audience, that is a cruel, cruel blow. Right, so she got 72% and she looks like a hard-boiled egg with a face drawn on it.
So how often does he want it?
Ten times a day.
Really?
10 times a day?
If he could, yeah.
Oh, well, they'd be chaffing. That'd be a terrible business. Well.
What do you think of this girl?
I don't know. Probably look better with the fringe off.
She might look better if you actually took the head off. I think she looks a bit like Prince Harry on the way to a fancy dress.
Okay, all right, then I'll go for myself again.
You're gonna go for yourself.
Let's see what the audience thought.
Oh! Exactly!
Oh my God, come on!
Okay, our final picture. Oh, God. Talk us through this girl. What do you think of her, Rosie?
I don't think there's no contest.
With who? Who do you think is better?
Me.
You think you're much better looking than her?
10.
Not even a contest. Well, audience, you're meant to vote now, but
yeah,
apparently there's no need because there's no contest.
So what do you think about you that's better than her?
Style.
So you're going to go with you, Rosie. Yeah. Okay, audience, who have you gone for?
Well, let's have a look. This is going to be an interesting show. This is going to be not only fun, but educational for you, Rose.
The madness continues with this clip from Family Feud.
Name a day of the year when you really want to be with friends.
December.
A car known by its initials.
Corvette.
If you could travel to any foreign country in the world, where would you go?
Pakistan.
Name something that can kill a lively party.
A gun.
Name a part of the body people dab perfume on. Yes, sir.
On the tongue, the tip of the tongue.
Okay.
We all have different strokes for different folks.
And something you buy in a larger size if you have a large family.
Jeans.
Name a reason you might stay indoors on a beautiful day.
Because it's raining?
Raining.
We'll play.
You're not planning to go to Cornell, are you?
No.
Name something men wear to bed, Margaret.
A nightcap.
A nightcap, Jeff.
Sweatsuit.
Sweatsuit AW. Yeah.
Nightcap.
Nightcap, Elizabeth.
Condoms.
A condom!
Here's a gaggle of clips that are either crazy, stupid, or just plain wrong.
Okay, now Daddy's gonna have to put the coat right over that. And then keeping your hands in your pockets, but working from inside, get the Bobo up and out of here. Take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. It's 55, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Go.
Watch what Daddy does. Just use my...
Yes, go ahead, boy. Just keep her going. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. Ooh, look at that. Just push. Keep pushing and pulling the coat down. That's it. Your hands in the pockets. Just push is the best way. Just keep pushing your face and everything else. Got 30 whole seconds yet to do it. It's coming. It's coming. That's the boy. That's the boy. Keep up pushing. Keep up pushing. It's almost out. There she comes. There she comes. There she comes. And the Bobo is coming! Keep her working! Keep her working! Keep her working! Pull out of the coat! That's it!
In this round, you will have to answer questions. If you fail to answer or if you get it wrong, you will receive an electric shock. If you get it right, you get a point. The questions in this round are all about Texas, because that's where they still electrocute people, if they're illiterate or black or if they've got a mental age under 10. Let's play. Complete the title of this film, The Texas Chainsaw... Jason.
Massacre.
Correct. Electrocute, Tali and Jez. Which American president was assassinated in Dallas, Texas in 1963? Jez.
John F. Kennedy.
Yeah. Electrocute the other two. She's not screaming like a girl. OK, the best little whorehouse in Texas starred Dolly who? Talia.
Parker.
Correct. Electrocute Jason and Jez. It's like an 80s robotic dancing convention. Which of Texas's surrounding states is the name of a famous musical? Jason.
Oklahoma.
Okay, electrocute Jason for singing the answer.
You know how we keep score on What's My Line?
Yes.
Finally, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Mrs. Bruce is self-employed and deals in a service. And let's begin the general questioning with Johnny Carson.
A service?
Mm-hmm.
I don't care what it is, I want it.
And now, I know you've been waiting for this. Here's Cindy Margolis with the number one brain freeze moment in the history of game shows.
The number one brain freeze moment of all time is this mind blower from Family Feud.
Name an article of clothing that children are always losing.
Their pants.
The price of a dozen roses.
$1.75.
Besides a bird, something in a bird cage.
Hamster.
Make a note of this show.
Well, there you have it, the top five brain freezes in game show history so far. Thanks for having me, Ben. Love ya.
The pleasure was all mine, Cindy. I want to thank everyone for joining us on Game Show. Moments Gone Bananas. And remember, it doesn't matter whether you win or lose as long as you've humiliated yourself on national television. All too true. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.